Welcome back to the Action Toy Art Podcast. Another tremendous and stupendous episode of the greatest toy show on the interwebs.
We really are.
I am Marked for Death.
I am Junior underscore Doom.
Eric Plays here. What's going on, everybody?
Toy fan.
The one cam.
And the one cam as always. Today is April 16th. It is Happy Rabbit Egg Day.
Zombie Jesus Day once again.
Jesus returns from the dead. This episode is going to air on April 17th. We have a lot of news today, so we got to break into that stuff because we got quite a bit. So as far as toy news goes, we're going to tell you guys a little bit about the Star Wars Black Series reveals that we saw from the Star Wars Celebration. We also got some images from the NECA figures for their Mego line. Marvel Legends had a leak today that we heard about, and also some Bandai America stuff, as well as some trailers that came out. So let's first talk about those trailers. The big deal. I haven't seen them yet because I'm on an anti-TV thing for the time being, so I'm not seeing any trailers as it is. Right. But we got Thor Ragnarok. Did you guys check this thing out yet?
I don't even know.
Roger says they should.
I was going to say, Roger's been going on a campaign of leaving comments on basically everything, even stuff not involved with Thor Ragnarok, and just leaving the hashtag. They showed.
So the one thing I saw was they showed Hulk in that.
Of course they did.
So they're obviously going to square off.
Images. Did they show John Cena is what I want to know.
No.
Cena.
Yeah. Hello. What's her face? Kate Blanchett. Great Blanchett and Valkyrie. I forgot her name.
I've watched her like seven times already.
I have no idea.
She's in a bunch of movies. She was in Westworld.
So were a lot.
Don't forget the Chaos Theory guy. Chaos Theory from Jurassic Park.
Oh, and Scourge. What's his face? The Dread guy.
Carl Urban.
Yes, he's in it. He's Scourge.
I'm a huge Carl Urban fan.
He's in that movie, then.
He's
not him.
So what does the trailer look like? I mean, did you think it looks really good? Did they show too much? What do you think, Ryan?
I think it's very colorful. It's very different from
the...
It's very colorful. It's compared to... Look-wise, style-wise, yeah.
Well, this takes place on another planet, so it makes sense.
No, and even that Rainbow Asgard, Bridge, bro. You know they're all about to kill us.
No, the way they did the Dark World was different. They tried to make it look kind of like a Game of Thrones, so they kind of they age everything, so it doesn't look as glistening metallic colors. So with this, they kind of went back to the first one. So it's everything's very crystal clear and very like shiny.
They're like, we've been making these movies for 12 years now. We left a bunch of stuff out. It got old and dusty and dirty. It's perfect now. We put it on.
So, yeah, I'm not going to take a look at this. I'll go see the movie. I love Thor, sure. So I'm going to go check out the movie, but I'm not
obviously
watching
Guardians
the trailer. I'm doing that anti-trailer thing.
Guardians soon, though, so we got to get ready.
They give away too much in the trailers. It's ridiculous.
It depends sometimes, too, because it depends on who, like, with Marvel, too. It looks like they're giving way too much, but really they don't.
And then the only ones that I actually end up enjoying are when they actually take alternate versions and cuts and use that in the trailer.
Right.
And there are times that you see that and you're like, oh, that wasn't even in the movie. And that's what really kills me is I think that they should actually inform you of that, too, you know, just so you can feel like you're like the Spider-Man fucking scene obviously is already ruined with the whole, you know, the that gang or whatever, you know, like we've all seen that scene of him being like, oh, the Hulk gives it away. It's like, so when that comes to the movie, it's going to be like, well, that's not funny anymore.
Well, it's a selling point. You know, you gotta have.
I really could care less about that Spider-Man movie. The rest of the movies I'm going to go see. Definitely Guardians of the Galaxy. That looks awesome. And Thor Ragnarok. So the other one that is getting a lot of buzz right now is that we got the Star Wars Last Jedi. That trailer came out. So I'm sure that was fucking some crazy heat. I didn't watch it at all.
I didn't watch it at all either. I saw my dad watch it today, but I didn't watch it.
I look away.
I looked at him watching it.
You looked at it on his phone. My brother showed it to him.
We know Ryan watched it, so Ryan. You can't stop consuming content. Tell us what happened.
Love the cons.
See, I'm not a huge Star Wars fan. It's okay. I mean,
But I watched it.
I'm always curious, so I always like watching just to have that knowledge. I like it.
Show me the good stuff.
I mean, it's nothing for me.
You don't need to do that when you already have glasses on them. That's...
Damn it. Only the people watching could see it, Mark.
He tried to like make himself look real cool and make fun of a nerd with glasses, but he's wearing glasses.
Yeah, but Ryan was nerdy.
What kind of a bully are you? Down.
My eyeglass.
Damn it, calling me out on my damn high things. I'm a damn dummy. Like this. Like he'd be wearing it like this. That's the way Ryan.
Okay, there you go. That's funny. Yeah, so Jared flipped his glasses upside down. We're all amazed at how creative he is. What's funny though is when Jared removes his glasses, his eyes disappear, just like Beaker and Skeeter.
Totally, no eyes once the glasses.
Just like no eyes in his glasses.
So when he saw it upside down, he saw the eyelashes peeking. They were down, actually like, trying pointing to kiss the my wrong beard.
Way. Yeah, it looked like you were sad.
Yeah, the eyelashes really trying weird. To kiss the beard.
It's like your eyes are just painted on the glass.
Yeah.
It's true. Just like Ski. That's why there's a reflection. The reflection doesn't, it kind of moves. Not really, though.
That's hilarious.
Anti-glare.
All right, so let's break into. So those were the two trailers for all of you geeks concerned.
I'm sure all of
you guys have already been salivating and jerking yourselves to these fucking trailers, especially considering one's Marvel and one is right. Star Wars.
I actually got into an argument with some fucking geeks today on Christina fucking Conan's Facebook page.
What happened?
Well, she proclaimed the same as I did. She was like, I fucking finally saw Logan, and she was like, I'm sorry, it was boring. And I was like, God, I was like, finally somebody else agrees that movie is
You thought just, that Logan was boring?
It's just boring. It's like, it's a drama. It's like,
it's drama.
All these things didn't line up together for me, and it would just.
They ended his life. They had to make it sentimental.
It was
yeah, but
so
we know that already.
Spoiler.
It's predictable.
Spoilers.
So, yeah, obviously, all these fucking dudes are just saying the dumbest, some of the dumbest stuff, you know? Just like, oh, obviously, you're not reading the comic book. I was like, dude, I just said, I don't care. I just wanted it to be a good fucking movie. I don't give a fuck if it has anything to do with the comic books. I don't give a
Wait,
fuck
what
if it's
comics, though.
Exactly. I don't, that's why I was confused. I was like, what are you talking about? Like, that, I don't even care. I just wanted a good movie. Like,
Old Man Logan's a completely different story.
I agree. So that he was more or less saying like, do you read modern Wolverine? And I'm like,
oh no, I
know what's going on. Kind of.
I mean, Old Man Logan's pretty modern though.
It's
that
old.
Was what, 2006? Later. That's later than that.
It's earlier than that, I think.
Over there somewhere. I don't want to
guys see they're talking about bringing out Venom movie again, starting a whole new Spider-Man universe.
Yeah.
About really? That life.
We heard talks of that, yeah.
Without Whispers. This Tom Holland kid?
Apparently starting off with perhaps Venom and like origins and shit and like going into all the Spideyverse characters as like its own universe.
They're going to just jack the movie. They're going to jack the movie life basically.
So they're basically going to
fuck it
all
up.
Well, it'll be more Spider-Man content I won't watch. Very good.
There you go.
All right, so let's break into the Star Wars Black Series reveals. If you guys are tuning in on YouTube, Ryan should be pulling up here in just a second, the second screen we got here, and then we'll talk about some of the new stuff that came out. So we got Star Wars Black Series. This is the 6-inch stuff. Of course, we're always covering 1/12 scale ship for the most part. But we got Grand Admiral Thrawn, the blueskin boy. He looks like he's oxygen deprived.
Yeah.
Cold, maybe.
He's not warm.
Where's this from, Eric?
This is Grand Admiral Thrawn.
From where?
From SDC exclusive.
No, like the actual source you said is from a book?
I don't know. I was kind of asking you that. Like,
yeah.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Either way, Grand Admiral Thrawn. So he's an SDCC exclusive. He's coming with like a big pack, and then he has all kinds of accessories. So he gets these like, looks like two dragons that are like looking at this ball thing. They look like some kind of like a...
Some balls.
I don't know what you'd call it. Some kind of an ornament or tchotchke that he'd have in his little...
He's totally got little, some tchotchkes, bro.
He's got tchotchkes. He's got like a goblet. Gift. He comes with a rebel...
there's a helmet in there,
Clone
too.
Wars helmet. He has, it looks like he's got some lightsabers or something like that.
What do you think this guy's going to command?
Who's this guy going to command? The fucking Smurfs. Look at his color.
Dude.
He's blue.
I mean,
he's Captain Planet's evil brother.
How much money is Hasbro going to suck out of you?
100 bucks.
You know, you'll be a good customized for Captain Planet. You're right.
Oh, God.
With his blue skin.
You could just make a blue face.
Yeah, you can just paint another.
Come on, I want some numbers here. What do we think?
Blue Man Group.
What do you think with prices?
Yeah, how much?
I'm saying this is going to be $65.
$65, Ryan. What do you got?
$75.
You
think 75?
Eric, what do you got? In American dollars, not Canadian dollars, Eric.
In Canadian dollars, it's like $100 all day.
All day.
$100 all
day,
bud.
You're getting this in Canada. Nobody's shipping this guy
over. Yeah, so he has like two of these like pillar things that like the Greeks would have normally put like a sculpted head of like David
reptiles,
or some shit. I don't know.
And then
they have like one's a rock. It's like a rock of some shit.
Those pillars are dope though, dude. Those are solid dope.
Those things look cool. Yeah, they would look good in sets.
I need a boot. But
those lizards
this
that
real
are looking
quick
at the planet look those like are shit. Hype. Those are dumb.
At least they're 3D. They could have just been an attachment, like
it could have
on
been
the wall piece. Yeah.
The crocodiles.
They
look so stupid. They look like in between a crocodile
and a gizzard.
It looks like, you know what I would use that for?
I would make.
And why are they
Geico
looking at a watermelon basketball?
I'd make Geico commercials out of those things, dude.
You'd make commercials out of these
Geico
things with these iguanas?
Geico commercials.
That's true.
Oh, Geico. They don't
Geico,
look like
bro
the Geico lizard.
You
he's a gecko
him
and he walks
customize
like
him
a man.
You can customize it. I would be
so
able to.
Why does this thing come with a Casey Jones fucking mask? What's up with that? Whoever wore that?
He comes with the Holy Grail that Jesus
he
drank
totally
from.
He has the goblet.
He has
the Holy Grail.
And then some fucking, you know, art piece.
He's got
or
some
whatever
Momo's lightsaber, too. What fucking Jedi ever gets caught slipping and loses his lightsaber?
He's got a T for time to leave.
Those are probably like Sith relics.
I don't know. Anyway, let's move on. We got lots of news.
This looks like a colossal waste of cash. So good luck to you nerds that are going to stand in line for 8 hours to fucking buy that thing.
I'm not.
This is the Battlefront 2 exclusive.
Yeah,
which...
so the Battlefront 2 exclusive. We got the Inferno Squadron pilot. So it's basically the exact same as the TIE fighter pilots. He just has red paint on him, which you guys can easily customize yours to do this.
That shit's hard, though. Those lines, that's some thin-ass line right there.
That's all deckles.
I'll deckle
you.
You
can do that, Eric.
It's all just deckles, bros.
That guy's taking a good fall off a fucking shelf, though. All right,
so now we got another one coming up. So we got the Jaina Solo.
Get it, girl.
So she's like actually in like a TIE or a X-Wing suit, it looks like.
She's in something. She's in my brain.
Yeah, it's like she's got her Rebel Alliance gear there.
I was going to say, is there two different versions of her, or is this one come with another head? Yeah, there you go.
I think you can remove it.
Or maybe just the helmet.
The helmet looks big, so I think it is just going to be...
Yeah, so she's got her...
Different hair,
pretty
too.
Big. Yeah, look at her hair. Yeah,
it's matted, yeah.
That's just a helmet. So she comes with like a breather thing. She's got some like weird bondage things around
her
legs, like those rapers used to wear back in the 90s. She's got a holster set up, her purple lightsaber.
She's got
Mace Windu's lightsaber.
Like if you're like battling with her, and you're like, your schwarch is not as big as mine.
We're not 100% sure what it is. I mean, yeah, that could be totally a double-ended dong that she's going to share with her friend.
It looks donging.
Big purple
No idea what that is.
No idea.
All right, so we also have Grand Moff Tarkin. So he's the new one. I think a lot of people are going to be picking that guy up. He's got
Grandma,
a very sinister-looking old man face, too.
He's army builder, though.
Why would he be? Or just because you could snap different heads on him?
Fuck yeah.
That would be a pretty good arm. But then you have a bunch of Grand Moffs. So there's just like a shitload of generals.
You could do a bunch of disorderly faced gentlemen.
You can do a, I guess, an old house.
Right.
What is this thing that he comes with? This is a droid mini version of the one-eyed, one-horned, flying purple people eater. What is
but
that?
He's black.
This guy looks like the guy from Haunted House.
Is that the there thing with the eyes from Big Trouble in Little Chinatown that floats
That's
around?
What it is. He turned into a robot.
It's just a droid version of it?
Yeah. It's that like they're stupid. Like, it's a clear stand. Like, that thing's got frosted tips on it. Why'd you frost tip the
But the grand base? The Grand Moff Tarkin looks cool, and then a bunch of people are going to have that purple people eater droid. They're going to have way too many of those if you guys aren't.
It looks like it's holding a pair of scissors and a pair of fucking pliers and a pair
yeah,
of...
Yeah, it's weird, right?
To snap your dick off.
It has that vagina spreader for, like, when they go to the OBGYN.
He's totally ready to snap your dick off.
Fine.
No big deal.
This one is the only one that I think I'm going to grab just because it looks cool. Mark's it's like the Clone Command 3. He looks dope.
He looks like he's in army fatigues for sure.
They just painted it camouflage color. It's like... weird that it's like white and then camouflage color. Wouldn't his fucking
his
everything else he has
totally
be camouflaged too?
Mark, you're going to have to blackwash that for sure.
Yeah. I'm gonna blackwash that. Why didn't they paint the boots?
Just gray boots.
Actually, on second thought, this thing sucks. This is all
computer generated photography right here. It's not even a final product.
Yeah, that looks like shit.
It's all computer generated.
Because like the lower half, like he's weathered where the camouflage and everything is. It looks sort of weathered, like they did some weathering to it. And like his chest plate looks good. His like the pieces over his shoulders look good. Those armor pieces, but then the actual helmet he's wearing has zero weathering on it. It looks like a really cheap-ass toy one you'd buy
at
Target.
He's like, I managed to get none of my helmet touched by this extreme fucking weather and shit.
Yeah, and then his boots look like they don't even belong on the body of the figure.
Right.
Like, they don't even look like they go. They look like they would be on stormtroopers that are just aboard a ship where they would never get a speck of dust on them. This doesn't make any sense.
Moving
this looks
on.
Terrible. And he has weird suspenders. Fuck this guy.
Wait,
I'm not going to get it.
Suspenders? He does have suspenders. All right, moving on.
I might get it. I don't know. I might fuck with it, but I might not fuck with it. You know, you never know.
Ooh,
you fuck with
it, look at that hat.
You can get it.
So we got the X-34 land speeder that comes with Luke Skywalker here. We got a new head for Luke Skywalker with some windswept hair here.
Windswept, too. Ooh.
And then he's got that hat would be perfect if you're making a Hunter S. Thompson character.
Might use Paulie's, but yeah, Mark's got a point.
Yeah. Because remember when he's in the desert for Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas,
he
has this
goggles. He's got the goggles too.
So he comes with a boonie hat and then these goggles.
You gotta have him covering up that beard too, like this.
But the land speeder looks really cool. If you get that, I would definitely be blackwashing that and then whitewashing it and then graywashing it and then doing some like brown wash.
Are you gonna
put
Vaseline under there too?
Yeah, and then put Vaseline underneath it with a mirror.
Yep. Genius.
And then when I take a photo, you just see me taking a photo of it because it's a mirror.
It'd be nice if this came with some like effects for the fucking thrusters or something like that.
You already have some, though.
Your NECA?
Yeah. I mean, yeah, we do have some, but...
Ryan, just because you're not white doesn't mean you can say that kind of stuff, right?
Yowzer!
That's their
word. What did I say?
My NECA.
I didn't...
You don't get a pass. You don't get a pass.
You don't get a free pass. Oh shoot! Look at that paunch.
So he comes with that hat. That's kind of cool. He has a baton.
That looks stupid. His trunk goes up though.
Yeah, that is cool. And I guess we get to see the motor inside there.
So where does? I wonder how they're gonna package this.
Yeah, him and the blind cowboy are gonna be best friends.
They're like, hey.
So what do you guys think price point on this? 45 or 35?
Ooh, this is gonna be like $50, dude.
50?
That's $100 all day, but
probably $100.
You think this will be $100?
Yeah,
the the previous one was like $160. The what do you call that? That stupid ship, the big one. It's $160.
Well, that's a TIE fighter. That's a bigger piece than
that thing was huge. That TIE fighter was massive.
No, but the thing is, it's pretty hollow. So
we'll see.
This
$100
you know that
Canadian
new
all day.
That new Darth Vader with the cardboard pop-up piece is fucking $75
already.
It's $75
I told you.
And but listen to this: the TIE fighter is right next to it for $99
Wow,
like that's a huge like that. That's only $20 off. You know what I mean? Roughly for something that's like way huge and worth it compared to a cardboard pop-up.
Did you get that TIE fighter?
No, I haven't got it yet.
Things intense.
It's gonna go down.
If I find it on sale, like super cheap, I might grab it.
I got it for $99 at Amazon before.
I think it's going to go down in price because it's at that $99.98 price point or something like that.
It was $65 before at Target.
Yeah, it went down for a while.
I missed that one.
Yeah, I admit.
I never wanted it. It's too much for me.
Yeah, so this Luke with the land speeder looks really cool. I think I'll pick that up. If it's $100, I'm not going to get it.
Dude, it's 112 scale. That's fucking dope.
Oh, and then he also comes with a long, like, old-fashioned rifle?
Yeah.
Whoa.
Blind cowboy.
Mm-hmm.
He's definitely the blind cowboy. All right, so now what we're looking at is the NECA Mego versions of A Christmas Story figures. We're looking at Ralphie. And boy, he's cute as a button.
He is super dolls.
What's it? And what is his pop's name? Did they give him a name? I can't remember.
George.
Yeah.
Is it George?
I don't even think they said it.
I don't remember that.
Last name Bush.
Damn.
He does look like George Bush. He sort of looks like George Bush Jr.
He just always said my old man.
Ralphie and the old man. Yeah, it does say old man.
All right.
Yeah, they never gave him a name.
So this is the Mego scale 8-inch.
So they come with different heads. So Ralphie comes with a regular face and then a smiling face. And then his dad comes with a regular face and then an angry face.
I wish he would have came out with like the cry face with like a broken glass. That would have been dope.
Oh, that would have been cool. You can make that, though.
Yeah, I guess.
It's by two.
He's not crying, though.
Because this, the standard face with just like showing his teeth, you could make that look like he's crying if you just painted it right.
Give him tears.
I like the old man's angry face, though. I think that's one of the best sculpts I've ever seen.
Yeah, that's a very discerningly face. Huh? He's just...
Then this one really from the profile, the old man looked just like George Bush.
He's going to be drinking and abusing that kid in those pictures for sure.
Slapping the kid.
You just mean Beryl's photos, right?
He's going to have fucking Kevin McAllister over and he's going to fucking abuse them both.
That's France, right, Ralph? And
good
Kevin.
Son, my ass.
And that's it. Thank you for toy art, I guess.
Thank you.
Okay, so other news. Jared got some news about Bandai America dropping some stuff. So tell us about what's going on with that, dude.
Well, I'm only being able to go and look at what's up on the Big Bad Toy Store, basically. So what I'm looking at here is basically looks like they are doing kind of like what they did back when Dragon Ball Z was originally popular, which is making packs of cheaper style figures that people can attain because obviously Dragon Ball Super is the thing right now, is super popular, and the whole thing is coming back. So there's breakdowns of a bunch of different like versions and figures. So we have here is like a three pack that they're offering for like $62.99, which it looks like they do have for the most part, like the SH Figuarts articulation. But as we know, getting all three of those figures for $63 is actually super crazy balls cheap. We don't see if there's any swap out hands or any accessories or anything with these. So maybe that's the whole gaff is that you are just getting, and we don't.
Oh, they have a build-a-figure, Shenron.
Really?
Yeah, so just right there. Can we combine to form Dragon Shenron?
Oh, so there's an even more of an incentive, I guess, because I guess I have that Goku, but I don't have that Vegeta or that Beerus. So I guess maybe if this is for you, yeah, it looks like they're the SH Figuarts, you know, but I can't imagine they would make it smaller, especially if you're going to do a build-a-figure. So, I don't know. So, I'm not sure at all what they're doing, how that's breaking down.
You have to buy, I guess, it says right here, both waves A and B to complete Shenron. So, I guess
yeah, then it says, too, Dragon Ball Super Stars Posable Figure Wave Set of Three with Shenron components as well. So this is the B wave, but it doesn't, it only shows.
They did that with the Power Rangers too.
Right. So it only shows an image like that. It doesn't show what it is. And the description is Dragon Ball rich history, blah, blah, blah. This wave includes Goku, Super Saiyan. Oh, I guess it's... Oh, and Frieza, final form Frieza.
Really?
So it's going to be Goku, a Super Saiyan, Vegeta. So it's opposite. So the next pack will be, he'll be a Super Saiyan instead of Goku. And then Goku will probably be regular. And then they're going to give you a final form Frieza figure. And then that will give you a part to build Shenron as well. And then there's a couple other just like blind pack ones and like staticky looking figures. So, I mean, it's kind of exciting, I guess, to be a Dragon Ball Z fan and remember how Irwin Toys and the Bandai did them back in the day. So this is just kind of cool for me. It's like a rehashing of how they did things back in the day, just to say. And then these two. So they have these freaking scouters here. Looks like they would be for cosplayers, obviously. They sold out fucking super quick. There's a Kamehameha one as well. That one sold out, looks like, super quick. So, I don't know. I guess it's just cool to see people are still digging on Dragon Ball after all these years because, shit, you know, all the new crap sucks. So, you know, you got little gimmicky toys like this. I don't know. This is just hitting the nostalgia for me, so.
That's cool. I don't think I'll pick up a single one of those, but they look cool. I mean, I respect it for those of you guys who are going to get those, but I don't respect it at the same time. You know what I'm saying? Like, I might fuck with it, but I'm not going to really fuck with it.
Yes, I got to do that shit.
Well, here's the thing. Goku is a cartoon, and Superman's real. So Superman can totally beat up Goku.
And zombies
easily,
are real,
all day.
Too, right?
Yes.
This is a good background piece. It's the Playmobil Ghostbusters. Have you seen those?
No.
What are you talking about?
The Playmobil Ghostbusters. It could be a nice background piece.
Wow, they did a Ghostbusters.
Oh, Playmobil. Mm. Yeah.
How big is that?
Oh, I didn't know they did any of that.
It's just pre-order.
That's like a bit bigger than Lego shit.
Nice.
Those have been around a long time, and I've never known anybody that's had those.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
They have a lot of accessories. Like
wow. Damn.
Interesting.
Super legit sticks.
Look at the car. The car looks good, too.
The whole thing, it looks
so But we don't have any of the actual characters. There's no Egon. There's actually... There's Janine, it looks like.
Maybe they're just, like, generic-y. They're just super generic versions. Yeah.
And then it's just, like, one guy and then a scientist downstairs that doesn't even look like Egon. Weird.
Pizza.
Pizza. Oh, there's a black guy, so... And then a girl.
So there's Janine and, I guess, Winston, but they don't even look anything like
them.
No,
those are like...
Janine sort of looks like
Those look like two chicks, actually, now that I look at it.
Are they two chicks?
Maybe this is supposed to be, like, the movie kind of...
The new one.
I like how the car's all drippy. Look at the car's got, like, just permanent drippies on it.
Yeah.
It's got, like,
permanent ectoplasmic reticulum.
Yeah, bro.
That stuff's real, by the way.
I know.
Ectoplasmic reticulum is flowing through our
Goku's
city
totally
right now.
Fucking fake, man. Goku's a fake piece of shit, right?
Goku's a cartoon.
Mark used to love that shit too.
Playmobil's real.
I don't even know what happened, man. He used to be.
I used to be really into Dragon Ball Z, but the last few years I don't like him anymore. Same thing with Power Rangers. I don't like them anymore.
All right, boys. So let's get into the icons.
No,
how we feel about.
We're not. We're not there yet. We still got to talk about the legends.
Oh no.
Yeah. So we'll talk about that. Let me do the legends rundown real quick. I took a snapshot. You guys off the list here so we can see. So there was a leak, and these are the Spider-Man Marvel Legends that are supposed to drop. So here we go. We got Spider-Man Ultimate, Miles Morales. We got Spider-Girl, Ashley Barton. We got Spider-Man Peter Parker. That one might be promising because maybe you're going to get like a regular-looking figure, or is it just going to be Spider-Man with an alternate boy head? It says Ultimate. We got Electro coming out, another one. Symbiote Spider-Man, Jackal, Miss Marvel, another one. Shocker. Green Goblin. These are already out, some of these.
Yeah, these are all,
It's the second half of the wave is what we're talking
Where
about.
Where does it start at? Beetle? It's, Tombstone?
Beetle and Tombstone.
Because I never heard of Dead Meat either.
Beetle's the girl that came out already, too.
Yeah, she already came out. Okay, so we got Tombstone, we got Cosmic Spider-Man, Moon Knight, which is cool. We're going to get a new version of Moon Knight. We already saw that before. Movie Spider-Man 2, Movie Spider-Man 1. We have the Demogoblin.
The Demogoblin
Spider-Man
nice.
Noir looks really cool.
Meow.
I think that'll We already know what it's going to look like. Spider-Man, so I'm excited about that. That'll be the tough one, I bet, to find.
I'm going to look forward to that one.
Another Mysterio. We got another Spider-Woman. We got Spider-Punk. This one looks dope. I'm excited to see the Spider-Punk.
Dude, a Mysterio is a big one to come out now, too.
We haven't had one for Toy Biz. I still got that motherfucker. That one's still dope as shit.
Spider-Punk will be dope. Prowler, and then we have Gwenpool.
Gwenpool's going to be hype, too.
That's interesting. So who is the Build-A-Figure? And why does everybody... It says leg. Oh, it's Legends. I see. Infinite Legends.
Oh, you got caught slipping, son. Hashtag, I don't do that shit.
Look, I don't give a fuck.
I don't know who the Build-A-Figure
is. I don't give a fuck. I hate you guys.
Gwenpool looks dope. Spider-Punk will be cool. Mysterio will be cool. Spider-Man Noir, Moon Knight, Tombstone. Tombstone, that's cool. I didn't think they'd ever make a figure of Tombstone.
They've been showing that figure now, so.
Yeah, that'll be cool to see that.
But, I mean, they are notorious for showing pictures and stuff that never ends up seeing the light of day. All right, so let's get into AI now. So do we feel like the actual thing is legit? And, you know, like, would we rather wait and have them fix the issue, which...
Oh, I believe it's 100%. I believe them. But I just feel like, Jesus Christ, like, this shit is taking a long-ass time. How long has it been? Over 2 years?
Not over 2 years. It was obviously it was October of 2015.
October 2015.
So by October of this year, it will have been completely 2 years.
That'll be exactly 2 years. Yeah. So they've had our money a long time.
Well, they haven't had our money. The fucking... I'm sure they spent it. I mean, that was the thing is like, we still, at the end of the day, still have to be impressed for having 17 figures up to spec in a line.
Yeah, I mean, it's cool. I respect what they're doing. I'm happy that they're going to go ahead and send all the hands back and make sure that everything pops on because they want it to be interchangeable. I'm totally down with that. I guess that they had leaked the stuff or they gave out a package to one of the other Momos, and I guess he fumped the... He did like a Facebook Live or, I don't know, Instagram Live of it, and I guess it was terrible. So I haven't
heard anything about her.
I don't even know who the person is. So they gave it to some fucking nobody that has no voice in this world. So it's kind of weird. It's too bad they didn't reach out to us because we could have done it properly with, you know, good lighting and shown people, given a real good rundown, and there would probably be great pictures leaked, you know, people already putting them in dioramas and stuff and not on the table. So I don't know, man. I'm excited to get them. I really want them to come out, but, you know, geez, just another fucking hurdle for these guys. I kind of feel bad, like, the things just keep...
I'm almost wondering at this point, like, if they're still interested in continuing with it, with how they've obviously been able, like...
After finding
people, well, and there's so many miffed people.
I mean, these guys work for toy companies, so they know what's up. They know that there's QC problems all the fucking time. I'm sure it's probably just par for the course. I think that's just dealing with Chinese factories. There's a huge barrier. So
until we hear something like, you're just not getting them, boys, we shouldn't even worry, really.
I'm positive we're going
to
get it.
I mean, I guess that is the one thing that it did shine a light to, is that we did see someone get them
and they were showing that
they exist, you know? So,
at this point right now, though, they said that they'd have to use a hairdryer or hot water to get the hands off easily, the arms off easily, and the heads and all that stuff. So I want them to be perfect. I mean, the Marvel Legends, they're great. Like, you can pop their hands off, and I've never had a problem with them.
They're going to come in and they're going to look like customs.
You think so?
Yeah.
I think they looked good. I saw somebody...
I thought they looked like prototypes still.
Yeah, I felt like they did look kind of like prototypes. They look like something that was painted like just at somebody's house.
When we get them, we're going to get them. We're going to get like custom legends pretty much.
But I mean
still, not knocking on anything.
I still think that if they provide what has been shown to be able to do what we've seen, then they are obviously better than a Marvel Legend would be, and, you know, they still will be a lot of fun and cool. So
but, I mean, we saw.
I wish they would have sent them to like Toy Arc or Action Figure Attack or somebody else who like would have provided a actual, you know, something in good lighting and done some good work. I mean, I didn't even know when that was going down. So I just heard secondhand that it was just a disaster. So that was kind of a fail on their part. I mean, geez, they could have really got those things out to all the different avenues of people talking toys. There's so many of us.
Right.
So it would have been nice if they just
sent even a handful. There's a lot of us that do it super professionally, you know. It's not easy. Yeah. Don't
it's not easy to do. Yeah, but at least set something up and make sure it's done right.
I mean,
put some good lighting in there. And I was disappointed. I was like, damn, they didn't even give it to like their head boy. Like, I mean, what's up with that?
Things. You gotta have an avenue to say, like, I've done this before. I know what to expect for this, you know.
Yeah, they should have sent it to one of those other guys that do things a little more professionally.
You live and you learn, I guess.
That happens. I wish the Articulated Icons guys themselves would just show us images of their stuff, because they said they got their own packaging from that email, right? That they hadn't sent to their houses.
Or maybe they just sent it to him. I don't know.
No idea. Oh, well. All right. Well, let's move on. Epic fail from them. Hopefully things will get better and we'll get our ninjas here pretty soon.
Speedball, I guess we could just say fucking NECA, Clark, Chainsaw, awesome.
Yeah.
We want that.
That's cool, yeah.
Dolph Lundgren joins Aquaman, I guess. Thumbs up, super cool. And then I guess Charles Band has released the rights to do a new Puppet Master, so another team is doing Puppet Master. You can follow them on IG at Puppet Master MOV and see their progress if you're excited about that franchise. So I'm going to give them the benefit of the doubt, you know. We're getting ready for that Evil Bong fucking next week. I'm ready. My nipples are hard.
I'm excited for Evil Bong. We're going to do our ATA 420 show. It's going to be fucking hype. We're going to have to keep it together. We got to keep it light. We need to drink some coffee during that episode because Eric tends to fall asleep. We're going to have to keep him awake.
Jared,
we don't want him to be all over the place and making fun of kids with glasses while he's already wearing glasses, which doesn't make any sense. And then Ryan, we're going to have to get that dude to crush up his Adderall.
Duh. Well, he knows how to crush, so.
He knows how to get.
He's not a player. He just crushes
super hyper focused so he can pass his exam so his father won't remove his left arm. Oh. You disgrace the village, Ryan.
Davirish. He's more like Davirish.
He wouldn't say that. That's actually very racist.
I know.
That's rude. It's quite rude of you.
I know.
So that's it for the news for the Action Toy Art Podcast. We have no beautiful sounds. Jared destroyed his computer. He said that the drive shaft came out of his computer earlier, and he showed us his laptop. The drive came out of it.
It's a drive shaft. It's a drive.
His computer has a drive shaft, a transmission. A, it has bro. Brakes.
Yeah. Don't be jelly.
His computer is a car.
Don't be jelly, bro.
So let's break into our weeks, boys. Eric, we need to have a heart-to-heart because...
I don't want to talk about it.
Eric, when you have rage issues the way you do and you abuse figures...
Slap him on the floor. Look at him. He's like serious.
Eric, look at him. He's really angry. So we need to address this as your toy fam. We need to talk about this.
Whoever watched my Instagram stories saw that my Mezco 112 Spock and Sulu took a fucking dive today. And they broke their feet off. They must have landed like fucking right on their feet or something.
They fell out of your detolf?
I don't know. I kind of agree... on Mark's theory about your kids doing that.
Right?
Kids aren't even here, for fuck's sakes.
Or Dana.
Yeah, what if the wife did it?
No, I heard them fall. Like, I was present.
Yeah, damn. But it fell on carpet,
so they fell off,
though.
And it broke the foot joints?
Dude, the fucking feet broke there off all is. Of them.
Now, what?
No.
There was nothing you could have done to save them? What about, like, using wax or putty or something for shots?
He's miffed, dude. He's totally like...
Or I could just break him.
No.
So you just tore him to shreds.
I told you, bring him to me. I will fix them.
They took another spill shortly after they fell.
No, they didn't.
They fell really hard from my fucking hand on the ground.
You know what? You showed on your Instagram stories the other day. You're turning into Sid. You were shooting action figures out in the forest the other day with a BB gun.
I saw that.
I was shooting
Adrian
toys.
Just joined the show. Oh, Dreadnoughts, we have the most entertaining man in toy photo history. Berol Mirado has joined the podcast.
I would like to say that I wish there would have been a follow-up video to that shooting.
Yeah, to see what happened. But Eric is just like this Cleveland shooter. He shows us he's about to cap somebody.
and then hides the evidence.
I'm like, why is he shooting gargoyles, TV figures?
Yeah, he shot the gargoyle. Wow.
They're like they're like airsoft guns, so they don't really do any damage to these things.
Right. It wasn't why do you have an airsoft? Oh, because they outlawed weapons in the Great Canada.
No, you have to have a license.
Oh, you have to have a license to own a firearm now?
Yeah, it's not
like, here where any fucking asshole can own a
gun. Any asshole. Well, it's not like you live in... Well, you mean your parents' house in Florida? That's where any asshole can have a gun.
Yeah.
I think you can have automatic weapons in Florida.
Yes.
Yeah, it's crazy.
I don't give a fuck.
That's awesome.
That's awesome.
All right, I feel like this is going to be like the longest show ever.
But you know what, boys? I didn't get any figures this week. I, in fact, lost 2 figures. So.
That's so sad!
So there's no way you can show us what the... I'd like to know what the bodies look like underneath the clothing.
Oh, they stain too, right?
They just look like the fucking... They're just like the Joker, and they're just normal bodies, bro. Nothing special.
But the pants stained, right?
What?
The pants, they stained on the legs.
Shut up, Ryan.
They stayed on the legs. Yeah, all the clothes stayed on. They just, like, broke apart within the clothes.
Did you just, like, throw them and smash them?
And just
break up, like, teeth? Like,
that's, like,
do?
All my Mego figures, drop basically.
Kick. I just fucking whipped them at the ground. I was so
you
pissed,
spiked
bro.
Them? Did it fuck up the heads or anything like that?
Oh, I'm sure there's... I didn't even look at it, really, dude. They're just a pile of fucking pieces.
Because I'll take those heads if you don't want those, man.
Like...
You know what?
Hey, what doesn't want head?
Yeah,
oh, Jared already called him.
I told him I was going to fix him for him, but I didn't know he threw him on the ground.
Dude, he fucking destroyed. Should have seen the images. When, they were mangled.
When they hit the floor, like right when it hit the floor, did like pieces come apart, or did you pick it up and notice
shattered.
It was loose? Oh, wow, like that?
I'm going to do that to my Punisher then.
Dude, I picked up the fucking figures and there's no feet on them. Fuck, thanks.
Wow.
Whatever.
Craziness. Craziness.
He's like, moving on. Shit.
I did that to that soda Dalsim. I told you guys that.
Rage smashed it.
Yeah. You can tell the rage in Eric's eyes.
Yeah, he's really angry. Okay, so Eric didn't pick up any toys. He didn't get anything. He
lost.
In fact, lost. He's negative toys this week. Did you see any good? Is there any positivity out of this week, Eric? You've been on a real bitchy run for the last few weeks. Tell us something good, buddy.
Tell me something good.
You know what else is good? I still don't have my Star Wars walls.
Oh my god, that's right. He's like, I got stuff. He's like, I totally got stuff.
You ordered those GPP toys walls and they never showed up?
No tracking or anything?
I think I ordered them when I ordered the fucking articulated icons.
Oh my god.
Wow.
Same way. Yeah,
those did come out a long time ago.
But didn't they say they don't ship it to Canada? I'm joking.
Oh my god.
Some of them you don't actually.
They
some
never
them,
send
yeah,
you tracking
you,
information.
You'll know
anything?
Right away on the address part. It'll tell you.
Yeah, it'll tell you. We don't ship there.
Yeah.
You better contact those guys, man. You might never get them.
This is kind of new. I opened up a Wanda.
I have a mint on card.
That's cool.
This is a great dial piece.
So yeah, that's a good dial.
It came with a sick dial piece.
Those candles are removable, too. You can show that. Those come out of the base.
It's a church stained glass window with removable candles and candle holders and shit, so it's really nice. But other than that, you know what? Ryan mentioned that, and check out this piece I found. It almost fits the Marv piece. Yeah, it almost fits. It's like another blown out part, so...
Yeah.
But also, I mean, fuck it for now. It's just what it is. It's a really nice piece by itself.
Also,
so.
If you have, it kind of goes with the, what's his name? Fucking, Ozzy Osbourne fucking one, too, because he comes with the like, stained glass, but it's like 2 of them.
Nice. I need, I need that.
It's a dope piece. I actually coupled it
with the Daredevil piece. I had it like that.
I saw that. That's cool, man.
Look at you. I was bust up your week.
It's just my week on Instagram yet.
Look at this photograph. Instagram.
Sweet weeks. As we wait. So patiently. Oh, ripper. Super rip right here. So we got a shot here, obviously, of the Marvel Legends Hulkbuster, and we have the chameleon body with the Tony Stark head, and he's like the Ghostbusters, you know, who are you going to call?
E.T. phone home.
So Eric was... You know what? Eric was,
this Hulkbuster is one of my favorite Build-A-Figures, I think.
You know, you don't want to paint it, though?
You always mention that you really want to repaint this thing, don't you?
I'd love to repaint.
I would totally repaint that.
And then make it look fucking hype stick.
It looks too. It looks too plasticky to me.
I would make that thing look so good, dude.
Or you can just buy the epic figure one.
Shut the fuck up, Ryan. I'm gonna throw this at my kid.
Why?
Shut the fuck up, Ryan.
I've seen people put lights and everything inside these fucking Hulkbuster builder figures. Right.
That's super cool.
It's a good shot, man. It's really really plasticky.
This was for the Ronin challenge was about weapons and shit, and I was like, you know what? Tony Stark's biggest weapon is his Hulkbuster.
He's got a big old weapon.
I thought his brain is his biggest weapon.
Oh, I thought it was Dick was his biggest weapon.
Yeah.
No, that too. Both.
We're all miffed here. We're all Tony miffed. Oh, I see the light.
Well, it's there somewhere. It's right there.
Right.
But yeah, I mean, I felt I got the idea across, so whatever. It's Hulkbuster huge in the background.
He didn't steal the idea either, we promise. Son of a bitch.
My hands will never be clean.
My hands. So we got a shot here, obviously, of the figures he's been talking about for a while that I've been waiting for him to shoot because he says he liked them and we gave him a hard time about them. But these are the Mattel figures. So we have the Batman in the blue costume. He's pretty much the He-Man
buck. The Greg Capullo version.
Mm-hmm. That is not the Greg Capullo version.
That's the Greg Capullo version of the Bat.
Obviously, we have the mutant leader.
Bat-Narc.
The mutant leader's on the ground. He has created effect here where it looks like he's used like cellophane to make it look like there's water and put various little pieces of leaves in there to make it look like it would be a like shallow-ass like watered something reservoir.
Yeah, right?
Lake, it looks nice, though. Right?
It looks good, man. I like the mountains in the background. Happy trees. We've got a valley in there.
Happy trees. Yeah, Batman's like, we're going to go out to this beautiful river and fight.
I'm going to use that saran wrap for a shot.
I'll saran wrap you face.
Yeah, I am. I'm going to use that for a shot I want to do.
Just, you know, you got to give credit where credit's due.
I'm going to use that idea.
You got to give credit.
I was trying to figure out how to do it. Yeah,
it's called stealing the idea, Adrian, and people will accuse you of it.
I'm going to saran wrap this shit.
I'm going to saran wrap.
They never did that on Gumby.
And then I'll saran wrap all the haters.
It's going to be, dude, you're going to need a couple rolls of that for all the haters.
Yeah, you're going to have to buy that industrial strength shit that Dexter was buying.
Right. Straight up.
All fucking haters.
So, yeah, super clean shot, man. Nice.
It looks good, dude. I really like it, man. That's fantastic.
Yeah.
Thank you.
That
fuck that
meat
leader. He's such a scumbag. He's a murderous psychopath.
It looks like he's
in water. It looks like the word that he's rushing over, too. That, too.
Yeah.
Oh, he's pissy.
Ryan goes
it's a climax.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, oh, beat me again, Batman.
That's not water, that's cum.
Oh, it's a Bukkake scene between Batman and Mutant Leader.
Wow.
It's
hard,
pee.
Too.
He's peeing on him.
He is, too. He's padding on him.
Mutant Leader cum.
Oh, that's in my week. We'll get on to people peeing on people in my week. Don't worry.
Good time. All right, so this one we got Spawn, and he's standing behind Wanda. This is really cool, man. I really like this. And then in the foreground, you put the cross, and then in the background, you put that stained glass piece. Very nice, dude. I love this.
Super clean.
Dude, I was proud of this shot. I like it.
What version of Spawn is that? Is that the new color, Tom?
That's his custom.
That's my Kit Bash.
Oh, it's that Kit Bash.
At least
they
called it a Kit Bash.
That's my Kit Bash, not a custom.
Not a
really?
Custom?
Oh, dude. Fuck.
I was actually really happy with the way this came out.
Like a dream sequence shot.
Mm-hmm.
I literally threw up just a bunch of fucking pieces in the background. Where the fuck
Eric's like, I just vomited this onto my camera.
I put soft lighting on
it. Look at Spawn's eyes.
It's glowing.
That's superimposing. Light. Superimposing a shot with green lights on his face.
Oh shit.
Yeah, but I don't know. I felt I got some like. Because it's always good when you can see some floor, whether it's in the foreground or whether it's right where the figure is.
I like the floor.
I like to do some flooring in the foreground a little bit too, like that. I think that kind of like brings the whole picture together, in my opinion. It makes it look more realistic.
For sure.
It's nice. I think this is one of your best ones ever. I
mean, floor is the hardest to pull off. Dude.
Maybe an artistic shot.
Thank you
very
much.
It is. There's a lot of stuff going on here.
Can you imagine the kind of dick pics I would take?
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god!
You gotta blackwash it.
Have the best one ever.
Though. You gotta blackwash it like Mark though.
I get the fucking lighting proper.
You gotta totally bronze nice fucking, it.
You can see the veins.
Mm-hmm.
I need to buy lights.
We all do.
But yeah. I mean, I was really happy with the shot. Just like, but what we always say: if you fucking pan out just a couple fucking frames, ghetto was shit.
Right.
How's that Wanda, by the way? Is she hollow?
She's kind of staticky, but she's great. The piece on her neck comes off, so it's like a veil piece that's just on her neck that could be removed. But the bird is attached to her hand.
How about the lower part? Is it like a thick, like solid piece?
It's a bird in the hand.
It's like a Barbie.
It's a hand in the bush.
Like a Barbie saw.
She's a good figure. I mean, she's very attractive. The detail is great, but it's pretty staticky. You know, she's got like three points of articulation, maybe.
This is the only thing you're getting out of her.
Yeah. But she looks, she's perfect scaling, so that's why I use her.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
I love anything Spawn made. I have two Wanda figures. I mean, Jesus, that's pretty awesome to be a Spawn fan.
Yeah,
I wanted this to look like it was like almost like the attic of a church.
Kind
of
yeah, thing. It does.
Because you that's know, attic, the off, attic feel. It's like a fucking. You can tell it's like musty.
Did you spray that nail spray thing in there?
I think I did too, actually.
There's a vape in there too.
Or dryer, whatever you're using.
Dude, I'm just using. Yeah, it's just a fucking like a butane-based nail dryer.
God damn.
Well, fuck. They use it for their nails. Why the fuck can't I use it for my figures?
Eric's gonna be the first guy in history to get cancer from toy photography.
Jesus.
It's like I dedicated my life to this cause.
And that talcum powder, bro.
Oh yeah, that too.
He never worked a day in his life.
The next episode of the Action Toy Podcast will just be Eric coughing up blood.
Right. Oh, shit. I didn't see this yet.
Dude, this is fucking hype, dude.
Nice. Oh, yeah.
So we got Pit and a little kid looking at him.
This was in your story, too. The BTS.
Behind I'm telling you, bro. This.
You get love your lighting on.
Yeah. There's light fucking everywhere in this shot.
Eric likes showing his pits.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah.
That pit is a great
There's
figure.
Lights
Rob brought it over to my house on.
Yeah, yeah, like on the thing, he had like light bulbs everywhere. I was like, holy shit!
Yeah,
I'm working with these two little fucking things. Like that came with a fucking light box.
It's different with the camera, isn't it, dude? The lighting.
Oh yeah, yeah, that's key.
It's you crazy.
The whole thing. Yeah.
You gotta
it changes
you,
everything.
You're like, you feel like you're flooding it with light, and you're like, I can't see shit.
Yeah.
The thing loves light, man.
It's really good, Eric. So who's the kid supposed to be?
That's Timmy.
They're in the same league.
It's fucking Timmy, bro.
He's part of the Build-A-Figure. Yeah, like, he's part of the Build-A-Figure 4 Pit.
Pit and Timmy in the comics, they're like a fucking like team.
Yeah, duo. Yeah. Kind of like the Wolverine and Jubilee. Almost.
Mm-hmm. But honestly, it's all about, for me lately, it's all about fucking putting things in the foreground to give, I mean, because you usually have this nice, like, forced perspective background, but you lose it without the foreground, I feel.
Mm-hmm.
So, having a nice piece like that, Spawn has that nice cross in the foreground, I feel if that wasn't there, the whole picture kind of could have, you know, wouldn't have looked proper.
I hear you.
But
it's the challenge, yeah. Though. I mean, I get it. You know, for you and like, you know, some of us, it's almost like you want to take shots at things, but in the back of your mind, you're like, unless it's kind of like challenging yourself or challenging your eye, it's really not worth it.
I mean, I knew this pitch shot was going to be super simple. It was just going to be these two looking at each other. So I fucking dropped like 7 lights on it and worked with some foreground diorama pieces like this, just because you're not going to always show just like a fucking white piece of floor or something. Mm-hmm. You'll hide it. Even if it's like a little tiny fucking piece, you'll just hide it with this. Right.
Right. That's what I do. Yeah.
In this shot, you can see how it's just slightly hiding the floor.
Mm-hmm.
But, I mean, yeah, for me, that's what I'm going to be working on a lot lately, is going to be a lot of foreground, bringing out the whole picture.
Mm-hmm.
So without this Timmy in the front here, it would look just like a snapshot, I feel.
Yeah.
No. This gets actually some real depth you can work with and let your eye fucking be like, oh, yeah, he's huge, right?
Some Johnny depth.
But other than that, boys, that's my motherfucking week.
Solid.
All right, let's go to Berol Mirado, since you just joined the podcast Berol. Quite a bit late, sir. Late bloomer here. Did you pick up any new figures?
What did I got the Joker.
Which one? Joker
the Suicide Squad.
Oh, there's like the Suicide Squad.
The Fig Arts one. Yeah.
Did you break the hand off?
I'm digging those Fig Arts. Know why? He's got an issue with it.
Just Eric. Eric's having a bad week with expensive
and they
figures.
They threw it on the ground and broke it into
and
millions.
I got a. I got him last week. I was in Miami. Commissioner Gordon.
Nice.
Garden from the DC Collectibles line.
DC Collectibles line. You also got Black Widow, right?
Black Widow too. Yeah, Black Widow too.
How much did that cost you?
It was $80.
Oh, that's not bad.
Yeah. A good old $80.
Good old
$80 make it hotter.
Was she worth it?
Yeah, it I would. I wanted it because Scarlett Johansson. I just wanted, you know, her
I
face.
I just wanted it for her.
You should put her on Ikashira's body.
Right.
With a dope little hair.
Yeah.
Perfect. I don't know, man. Not really. I don't head swap that much. I don't head swap enough.
Are you loving your camera still, man, or what?
Yeah, yeah, just starting to get into it more.
Are you shooting it on auto still, or are you doing some different stuff now? You starting to play with it?
On and off. I've shot it in aperture mode, and then I've done a couple in just all manual.
So, Berol, are you noticing like what kind of a new world is opening up for you now as far as what your photos are going to be looking like?
Remember, Eric couldn't wait till you got a camera.
I'm just serious. Eric,
I can't wait till you get a camera.
Everything's... it is. Everything is different, bro. Everything's different, though.
Yeah. But better. Like, different in a better way.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Just it's more clear. Just looking back at it now, I'm like, fuck. Like, even now, the other day, I was going to shoot something, and I was going to do it with the phone, and I was like, no, fuck it, I'll wait.
Right.
Dude, you want the depth? You want the quality?
Yeah,
of that?
Yeah, yeah.
You're right, though.
I want to get another lens, you know? Yeah, yeah.
Now, do your shots, do you have the Wi-Fi thing on your camera where it automatically transfers the images to your phone?
Yeah, yeah.
Did you do double check and make sure you're getting the highest quality image when you do the transfer?
No, I have not.
All right,
we'll have to go over it with you later.
He has Sony, though. He has a different...
Your photos will be less grainy.
Still might be the same. Yeah. You gotta check. You always, yeah, check your settings, man.
I know they're... I think it's in RAW is what it's coming.
That's not
you're
good
shooting, yeah, that's the way you're shooting. I shoot in RAW, too.
You shouldn't be shooting in RAW.
No.
How should I be shooting?
Fucking L.
What's L? L?
Well, I'm telling Loser. Mark. I'm telling Mark that.
I'm shooting.
He's got the
I'm shooting
camera.
On M.
You're on M.
I'm shooting on
M. No,
on menu.
No, I'm always on manual.
Always on
this
manual.
This has to do with.
We mean
this is
like,
inside the camera's guts.
When he says RAW, he means fucking like RAW.
Oh, I like the file. He's
yeah.
Yeah.
And there's no
it
reason.
Should be L.
There's no reason for Mark to be. Ryan, are you backing me up here?
Well, it depends. If you're gonna sell your photos, then you should do RAW. But if you're not, if you just do it for your hobby, just do it in JPEG, since it does not make any sense for you to keep it in RAW.
Right.
Especially if you're not gonna do a lot of post processing on it, don't bother doing it. Only do RAW if you're shooting outside, since you're doing shutter priority.
That's it like that. You know?
Right. So if you're outside doing shutter priority. Without any control with the lighting, shoot RAW. But if you're doing inside and you're not going to sell this photos.
You're not going to sell this photos?
As a hobby, just do a JPEG. It doesn't. It's just going to take up a lot of space on your hard drive.
Yeah, I'm going to go with option two. not sell this stuff.
You're not selling your stuff?
The not sell this photo stuff.
Not to sell.
All right, so shoot on L. I'll have to change that when I do that later. All right, so did you see any new movies or anything like that, man? Anything? Because you got us hyped on D-Train. By the way, did any of you guys watch this
movie? I still didn't watch. I saw the thing.
Oh, Jared, you've been caught slipping now for about a month. You need to catch up to D-Train, and you need to be as uncomfortable as Adrian and I when we were watching. Just strange, and hilarious film.
Yeah.
I think you need to really watch Silo first.
If you watch it by yourself, you'll like be laughing like extra loud just to break the awkwardness that's in the room by
it's
yourself
so
there with you in the movie.
Darkly awkward. It's so fucked up. Oh my god! You have to watch it. I can't believe you haven't seen it, dude.
I've been busy watching other shit.
You watched Kung Fu Panda 2 for like the 18th time.
I love that. 3. Movie.
God damn it!
I saw Netflix. No, Anna Clarita Diet.
Yeah, I started that too. I don't like it.
You didn't like it?
It's got Timothy Elephant and Drew Barrymore.
He's great.
Yeah, it's a little like the first episode. I was like, bro, this is like, because I saw it on the plane. You know, I saw them all on the plane.
Nice.
And, like, I saw the first episode and it was a little, I don't know, like a little off. But
but it's not great.
Yeah. I thought it was cool.
I thought it was
and
cool.
I'm watching now. I saw all of it today. They had the marathon today that I was watching, and the new one's tonight. I don't know if you guys watched this, The Leftovers.
Oh, season two. Oh, The Leftovers.
I watched the first episode.
Yeah, you guys watched it?
Mm-mm.
We don't
watch
that
shit. I saw the first season.
Yo,
second season.
Is it on HBO?
Dope, man.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, like the first season, those first 2-3 episodes are fucking brutal. Like, they're really slow. Like, you've got to try. But after that, it's fucking... Like, yo, I was fucking. I sat through those three and
articulated
the fucking show.
Good work, Eric.
I dig the show.
I dig the show now after bearing through
really?
A couple
shows. Dude, I couldn't even get through the first episode. I shut it off. I was like, this is terrible.
Yeah, that's how I was, bro. And then I came back. To
Barrels
it.
Were sticking it back in there to sometimes. It.
Wow.
Like, I got faith in this.
He sticks it out sometimes.
And but it's good.
Well, maybe
it's really
I'll
good.
Check it out. You said the first season is slow.
The first 3 episodes.
Okay. I think the whole season is slow.
But it is.
I watched.
So maybe I should just watch like a brief synopsis
just
of the first season and then just break into.
Oh yeah. Or right watch like the last 3. Episode of the first season, the last 2 episodes.
See, even with they got last, that, even with that, the last that, episode in the last season, it didn't really grab me that way.
Then why are
like,
we
oh,
talking
okay.
about it?
All right, this show sucks. You guys, all right. So, Adrian, anything else that you want to tell us about? Did you see any other like new movies or anything like that?
Any new movies?
What did you think of the Thor Ragnarok and the Last Jedi trailer? Did you see those?
Talk about that.
No, I have not.
Told you.
You're watching Fast Times for Ridgemont High for the 160.
I have not. I mean, you can tell from my stuff. I'm not big on the superheroes.
Right.
Except you have Black Widow and Harley Quinn.
Yeah.
That's because they're
yeah, but that's
people.
Different. Like I'll.
Well,
what
he loves
what
bad
I want
bitches.
Is a
that's
Superman.
His fucking problem.
Yeah. Superman or Spider-Man, but I don't have those. I need to get. That's about it.
Let me know.
But
what
like,
you
I'm not.
Man. So we were talking about the Christmas Story Mego figures. Are you all over those too? Kevin needs a fucking roommate.
Ralphie and the old man.
Oh, I haven't seen that.
Well, then I guess you got to watch the show.
Wake up from your slumber. I don't know what you're doing.
I'm
oh,
slumber.
Shit. Eric's going to slug everybody.
He's got a slugger.
Eric. You can't avoid this stuff. Oh. This is dumb. You can't Popper do this on this. Yeah. All right, so Adrian's week was completely a dead.
of He's like, I went to Florida. Yeah. Suck it. Did you do photos?
No, I did a couple over there, and that's it. I just been lazy. I got here.
Lazy.
Back home.
Last
back
night,
to
I left.
Just yeah. civilian life again outside of the war zone known as Florida.
Oh,
the
shit,
eco terrorist.
Yeah. Gordon got caught.
Last
slipping.
Night, I did like five or six, like, I don't know, good picks that I liked.
Very
last
cool.
Night.
All right, so we're looking at your weekend Instagram right now. So we got Commissioner Gordon.
Oh,
he's pointing a gun at the Joker, and then Harley Quinn has got her goodnight bat. She's showing up behind.
Figs right there.
We got that Extreme Sets diorama with the backdrop there. Very cool. Very cool.
Gordon, I wanted to get the Alley one, bro. They're no more. They're sold out of stock.
Really?
Yeah. I even asked him. I was like, hey. He's like, no, that's it. Unfortunately, wow. We ain't gonna have no more. I said, damn.
What did you say, Eric? You were
the
saying?
Deranged Alley.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I said this Commissioner Gordon, actually, this the look of him, like the realistic look of him goes well with these SA's figure arts figures.
Mm-hmm. Oh. We also haven't seen Gordon in this universe, so we don't know what the fuck he looks like.
Oh, this is Icons?
No, that is the DC Collectibles.
DC Collectibles.
Yeah, that's Icons, isn't it? DC Collectibles Icons?
No, that's a
seven. Yeah, it looks like the same box.
It's like a 7.5-inch figure. Or just
it's the same kind of shape. Their boxes are similar.
Yeah, it's a DC Collectibles. He's tall.
I think it looks cool. I like that figure.
He's got double articulated legs.
That's the one where his arms don't go down.
His arms don't go down.
Weird, and apparently they break easy too. So.
Yeah, watch out. I told
you.
I'm
not going to get that figure. Never mind.
I've been real careful with the arm.
I got two of them. They both did it.
Barrow. If it does break, smash it on the fucking ground.
Right. Send it to me.
And post the pic.
I want to destroy something beautiful.
You guys are devils.
Right, I like his mustache.
Cool. That one got 18,000 likes. Yep. All right, here's another one. Celebrating
Bad
two
bitches.
Girls, one bong. So we got Hillary Clinton sitting next to Patty Mayonnaise.
Patty, man.
And they have a bottle of soda in front of them. They got raw rolling papers, that raw tray. And then she's got a dabber or a little bong. And then Hillary Clinton's about to hit that huge blunt.
Hillary Clinton. It's S.H. Figuard, Scarlett Johansson, and S.H.
Oh, I thought
Figuard,
that was Hillary Clinton. Oh, wow.
Margaret.
That's a nice sofa. I like that sofa.
Hobby Lobby.
And the table.
Hobby Lobby.
Same set.
And then that gigantic stucco in the background.
And it's gigantic stucco.
It's even still a bit small in SH figure art. So
right, yeah. Those
things are very small.
They are small.
Yeah.
They're for dolls. I mean.
Oh, and we do have
dolls.
Well,
they're for their
those
brand.
Dolls,
dollhouses.
Yeah, but right. I think I've even sat fucking Jason on there and shit.
Yeah, they all work. I mean, you can get it to work.
You know, you angle it right. You know, it'll work. But Jason's like already big for it, though.
He lays down on it, talks to a therapist.
Right. He's got troubles, man.
Oh, I miss my mom.
Troubles.
It's very cool, man. Where'd you get the lighter?
It's Chop Top.
What? You had to rip it Look off it. Of his hand?
No, it comes in his thing. It's a little extra. It comes with a hanger, that lighter, a hammer. The little old school, like, barber switchblade knife.
And then he has the hand that has the lighter on it.
Straight razor?
No, they don't have... Yeah, straight razor. They don't have a... His hands are free. Like, they don't have nothing in them.
Wow.
No way. This is the NECA, the last one.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I'm surprised you don't have that, Jared. You always talk about Chop Top. You've masturbated to Chop Top.
Well, I have the 7-inch one.
Yeah,
and
he's got like a little, that little.
Well, you could always
wig
use an exchange up there.
I'll change you up.
His little wig. He comes with that little ball wig. You could like jizz into it if you want.
I can't wait. Jizz into it.
Perfect.
This one I love, dude. So you built a little, it looks like studs on the wall there, like in his garage.
Yeah.
So we're looking at the NECA, Texas Chainsaw Massacre, inside of his little lair. and he is chopping some things up. You can see his chainsaw there. He's got the
wiping blood on everything. He's got
the Texas Longhorn symbol hanging out there.
Yeah. That's Jared at work.
Yeah,
that ain't no Longhorn. I tell you what.
What?
Where did you get that cow skull or the bull skull?
From Mini Materials.
Nice.
Mini Materials. They sell that, yeah. Huh? And they sell those cinder blocks too?
No.
Yeah, cinder blocks.
Oh, that's the same little company?
Yeah, those little like 2x4s. Mm-hmm. They got little bricks. They sell a bunch of little things. They got little
how much does that stuff cost?
Little jersey barriers for the skaters.
Yeah.
Very cool stuff. Very cool products.
Yeah, they got a lot of cool little stuff there.
They have like
how much does that stuff go for though?
I think the those bricks, I think it's like 50 of them.
The cinder blocks?
Yeah, I think it was like 50 for like $20, and it comes like on a little pallet too that you can use.
Yep. And nice. Then what about the 2x4s?
2x4, I think they were like $8, $10, something like that. I don't remember.
And how much for the severed foot?
That was like $800, I think.
Oh wow! And then the bull skull. How much does that go for?
I can get you a toe.
No, that shit was. I think that shit was like $8 or something like that. You know, and again, I could be wrong on every single one of these fucking quotes. But these are all ballpark.
I don't know numbers.
Oh, ballpark.
We're gonna get somebody to go on iTunes and start ranting. Barrel was totally incorrect about how expensive these products are. I like your 420
heard
likes
of
too.
These guys before. What is it Rich called?
Like 50.
Mini right. Materials. They even sell like they even got like a little mold thing to make the bricks. You know what I'm saying? So you just buy a little mold and a little thing and make as many as you want.
Go buy your own cement.
Yeah. Like, he has, like, the little...
Wait, they're real cement? They're made of cement?
No!
Yeah, or whatever he sells. I mean, it looks, it feels like it's cement.
The fuck?
It feels like it's it cement.
Yeah, it does.
That's crazy.
Bro, it is, for real.
So they possess the technology to shrink real-life building material.
I guess.
And he's got little, like, the little red bricks.
They're real.
I wonder if Zelensky's in on this.
Yeah, he is. It's got to be heavy.
Right?
But they're so small, though, Jared. I mean, they are heavy.
Still, they are giants.
They would be heavy.
So let's be shrinks them. So they're light.
They would be heavy.
Plastic
in the
mail. Is heavier.
The ant could carry those kids.
Plastic's got to be heavier than sand.
All right, so we got Jason walking in a forest of gigantic trees.
It's actually in the parking lot of my Toys R Us.
The parking lot? You just bought the figure and you're like, I'm taking it out.
It's in the parking lot of my Toys R Us, actually.
The parking lot has grass.
That's where you hang out and you solicit.
Not in the actual Toys R Us, but like in the parking lot of the mall.
How many people saw you do this?
There's like a dog shitting in the background.
No, this is where like the
bus is. That's what that is. That's a huge log coming out of a dog's ass.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
How many people saw you do this?
I don't know. I don't think any.
Roughly 70
people. Like 1,500 people?
Yeah. I mean, that I saw me? None. But that actually saw me? Who knows?
Hundreds.
What's that autistic boy doing playing with his toys on the grass? Over there?
I mean...
Like, he must have stole that camera.
I know.
Is he smoking a joint?
In the figure.
Rest up.
Yeah,
man.
Yeah.
They're like, he couldn't even wait
to right
open
there.
He couldn't even wait to open the door. He took it outside right away and shot it.
No, that's mine that I've always had. Right where I'm shooting from is like the sidewalk. Like I just park right there and get off and put him on the grass.
So much effort involved.
Everybody saw you then.
It's a good shot though, man. It's very outdoors.
I think it looks cool.
Jason.
Do you always have your camera with you now? Whenever you go out?
Well, no.
On that thing
I knew I was going to shoot this with, you know, so I took it with me. Because I did this, and I think I did something else that day.
Something else.
He looks like
a geographic photographer now. He's deep in this shit.
He's deep.
Here we go.
He's got like a fish vest on filled with fucking lenses.
Look at him using all of his props now. Now he's trying to be a rock king.
Oh, that was, wow. He's coming for my title. Oh, for,
yeah, that was my racist little Chinese that thing there.
Racist photo, yeah.
Wait, what?
You got the Asian was, food and yeah. the Asian cop, racist.
Yeah, I was racist. Like, dude, that's what he says. I was like, well, that's just in the questioning rooms. There's always Chinese food.
There's always Chinese food. Always, it's a formality.
Oh, because there's like some. Chow Young Fat shakeout in there.
Chow Young. But yeah, this is
wait,
a fun
so somebody
shot.
Called
I mean,
out, called you out,
to...
and said that's racist.
So what we're looking
yeah,
at...
Ryan here called me out.
Jesus Christ, Brian.
So we're looking at here.
You guys are always looking to complain about something.
That's what I said. I was like, whoa, you're reading in too deep. My little racist friend.
So we're Duper looking at racist. Is Beryl was able to take one of the panels that comes in the subway set and turn it into what would look like the inside of a questioning room
yeah.
inside
That's
a police
perfect,
building. He's obviously got the phone there Rafty. That comes with Janine from Diamond Select Ghostbusters and the racist takeout Asian food opened.
Oh, you know your props.
I know my props. I'm prop king, bro.
The prop king. He's questioning the Joker. Very cool.
The Joker.
And then what's that cop doing in the background back there? Was he the guy that made the Chinese food?
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. Yeah.
Exactly.
No, he's a Chinese delivery man.
In a cop uniform. He has to get two
he's
jobs.
Guarding the door, bro.
He's guarding that door.
Hey, so
oh, you guys.
We need to boycott this podcast.
Very nice shot.
Beautiful shot.
It's good.
Man.
I really love it, man. This is a really good shot. Call it off,
guys.
Oh, God. Of course, he had to return to his original.
Scully.
Are you
Scully
like holding?
Getting...
Are you like holding her?
No, she's on a wire coming from a like a thing on the side there.
Okay.
That's so dope. I didn't see this. I love it.
Well, that's how
we got
she just
David
came
DeCruppy
out like that.
Reaching up for Scully. This is so fucking cool. Wow.
Classic alien beaming people up.
He's a beamer.
So it's a good shot. The background is like nice and it just looks like any park or something like that. And then she's just getting beamed up. How did you do that? What effect did you use?
I just said.
That's the
Oh, what effect?
The blue stuff?
Yeah. The blue stuff!
The alien ray?
Alien.
Yeah.
Oh, so that's, it's from that light effect shit?
That's from the, yeah, the lens effects. That's the jet exhaust.
Ooh.
That's really good. I love it.
With some little particle boom.
Whoa.
You're really getting into your microphone there. Be careful.
He's eating it.
Yes.
Yeah. He swallowed his
microphone. What did you say?
Oh, my God. He's Adrian. Are you like screaming into your microphone? This is how we hear
it. I didn't hear what you said.
All right, guys. So we're gonna.
Just talking about gremlins.
You notice we took off the seatbelt signs. We just wanna.
Are you on the plane?
He's actually a pilot. He didn't want to tell us.
Oh my god! Why didn't you do another snakes on the plane shot?
That's a fantastic shot. That got 7,000 likes. That's fucking incredible. All right, next photo.
Right, oh my god.
Dallas
Bug.
Well, come on in, sugar.
I think this went over like
Jared Leto head from the fucking...
I think this went over like a lot of people though.
This
went
is so
over
funny.
A lot of people.
Yeah, like last was over there. I think, you know, like didn't know that this was from that movie. You just thought, like, you know, what the fuck is this?
It's so funny.
I haven't seen the movie, so I don't
get Jared Leto head on the Harley Quinn body, so he looks like a transsexual.
I took off his tattoo, too, on the forehead.
Oh, yeah, you did.
Oh, yeah, you flubbed it out. That's so
good. Yeah, he totally does.
That's so good. He looks like he's got AIDS.
Is he
and
in
all, everything, everything.
Is he in Dallas
Buyers
Club?
Everything that was on his face, I took it off.
That's so cool. So who's the guy in the background?
That's McConaughey.
I know it's not. Look, I understand.
It's McConaughey. It's the Mego one. You bought that two-pack Mego shit?
That's actually McConaughey, though.
A figure of him. I forgot about that.
It's McConaughey.
No one shoots that figure.
Yeah. I know somebody who shoots that figure.
I've seen him shot.
Yeah, he gets shot. That's the two-pack one. Him, so you had to get two, right?
With this girl, too. What's her name? The other girl. I can't think of her fucking name, though.
This shot flew over people's head, he says.
Huh?
You said this shot flew over people's head.
Like, bro, to me, this is a really good movie. Like, I've seen this movie a lot of times. Like, if it's
a lot of times.
Yeah, it's a dope movie, bro.
It's a good movie, yeah.
I haven't seen it.
That's a really good shot. I love the
concept. Is Jared Leto in that movie? I didn't know.
That what happened?
Jared Leto is in that movie, I take it.
Yeah. He's like a tranny.
That's the one we lost all that weight for.
Yeah. Well, he was somebody that had AIDS in the film.
Before he became the Joker, right?
Yeah.
He was really good in that. Like, that movie's great.
Both of them, like, were skinny as fuck.
Yeah, dude.
Like, this guy in his face, too, was big time.
All right, so now we got an Echo and the Bunnymen shot here.
It's Frank. Frank the Boonie.
Bunny from Donnie Darko here. That's very cool, man. I like that.
That's the RV park that I go to
and shoot in the back.
Action figures out there. I saw a lot of bunny shots today.
I got two bunny figures. I don't have this figure, though.
Bunny that's worth having would be a dope-ass Usagi Yojimbo.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise,
I got that one, too, I guess, yeah. You're cutting in and out, Mark.
Yeah, Morse code style.
No shit.
Mars code.
No shit.
So yeah, very cool. We got
looking out.
I think I take a lot of shots.
That what?
I always think I take a lot of shots, and then we get into your week.
Well, I didn't do anything last week, so I was just.
Didn't do anything last week. Dang, he's still Racky. Pumping.
Easter.
He dropped like what? 10
hours ago.
Four photos today?
48 likes.
What happened?
You dropped four photos a day, right?
Jesus. What the fuck? Four photos?
I got like six or seven. I got like six or seven that I did last night.
Take it easy, bro.
Huh? You ever leave your fucking house?
Like, this one I did this morning, actually.
For sure. It says 10 hours ago.
Like, when I woke up, like, I cracked an egg open, and I was like, fuck.
Fuck? Is there all the bunch of fucking
eggs? Just like a weed coming out of it.
Did you clean that out, at least?
I saw, like, an egg of weed on Instagram.
We're blowing it for our audio listeners. So this is a photo of Freddie Mercury is cheering while Bruce Lee cracks an egg open, a giant larger than an ostrich-sized egg. This would probably be a terror bird egg. And then Igashira is cheering him on as well. And as he cracks it open, weed just spills out of this egg. And then,
I like how he's still holding the pose after all that weed.
It was an instant. It just poured out instantly, bro.
It poured.
Falling, yeah.
Beautiful.
Yeah. It was like, yeah.
Hilarious, dude.
Harry Larry.
How the hell do you come up with these ideas?
Well, you sent me a pic of weed with an egg with weed in it.
Oh, I did.
That's how that happened.
Oh my god!
And I was actually gonna put Kevin hitting it with a bat.
So why don't you put on there inspired by Mark's poke?
Oh,
he said to
shit!
Me. That's the thing. You ain't giving me credit, and that's the problem.
Because you didn't post it.
Y'all ain't giving me credit. You need to get credit because I need recognition, and y'all can't be doing this without.
Nobody would know. So we got mixing universes.
Yeah, it was a DM
here.
I'm telling you right now, to your goddamn face, it was from the fucking picture you sent.
Hostile. All
right, so we got Carl handing off Easter eggs to a girl.
Or huevos, like Ryan would like to say.
Huevos.
Touch my huevo.
Huevo.
So what are those things?
Those are eggs.
Is that what cocaine looks like?
Huh? Yeah. Cocaine eggs.
Oh, yeah. Those are actually little heroin packs he coughed up.
Out of his butthole.
He took that across the border. He's a mule.
Why is Frank the Bunny? What's Frank the Bunny doing in the background? Did he shit those out?
Yeah.
I mean, possibly.
He's a watcher.
They have Cadbury jizz inside of them.
They don't see him at all?
I think Carl would have totally saw him because that was when Carl still had two eyes.
I don't know.
Shit, you're right.
The peripherals ain't too good.
Carl with his one eye. Son of a bitch.
Who's that girl? What's she from?
Walking Dead. Beth. Yeah, Beth.
Beth.
Oh, that's Beth. Right. Jesus Christ, I forgot about her. She's been long dead. Fucking really? Daryl.
Yeah, dead for a while.
Is that blood splatter on his face?
Yeah.
Is this another shot? Jesus.
Oh.
Ryan oh, that's like this one. Right? Ryan yeah. Caught slipping too. Look. Oh, shit. He liked it.
Oh, another one? Damn. So this one.
He's obsessed with eggs today.
So now we got Iga Shear hatching an egg. And it startles Bruce Lee as he has a chisel and a hammer.
Oh,
and then
God.
Camilla and what's that? A Lego chicken man in a chicken suit runs away?
It is a chicken man in a chicken costume.
I just threw them in there for good measure.
For good measure.
What came first, the chicken or the Iga?
Is that what it says?
It's only one G.
That's a good pun.
You fucking maniac. This is what happens when cannabis.
That's great, you know? I love that caption.
This is probably another pick still.
What I want to know is, did you clean out that eggshell, or now is this Iga Shear actually come with live salmonella?
No, it was cleaned out.
It was cleaned out.
I had to put weed in there, so that shit, you know, it was washed and.
He's like, I'm gonna smoke that.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go smoke salmonella.
He gets salmonella in his lungs.
Right.
You can tell he just grabbed Iga Shear and fucking jammed him in there, too.
I know, look at,
no, what do you mean? He's taken apart. There's just two legs and just his top torso. That's what's in there.
Nice.
Oh,
he's in pieces. He's in pieces in there.
He's very careful with his toys.
Yeah. That is fucking
hilarious. Ryan's like, God, are you sure you're not Asian?
Because he comes apart to put on that fucking, that dong underwear that he's got. So... You know, I just took them apart and stuck them
perfect.
In.
Perfect.
That's a.
You're becoming Asian, Beryl.
Huh?
You're becoming Asian. Is the last one?
Can't hear you.
You're becoming Asian.
Is this the last one?
Jesus Christ, Asian?
Dude. Yeah, you're becoming Asian. Every...
Oh. I don't know. He's funny to me, dude.
It's funny to me. Does it always have to be funny?
And it started out with just like. Just his torso, like the legs weren't there. And then I was like, oh, then I stuck one leg. And then I stuck the other one. And I was like, oh, look.
It's pretty funny, though.
Yeah, the best part is the caption. I love the caption.
The best part is the caption.
Yes. I think that's it. Yeah, the last one.
Oh, wow. 2 hours later.
We reached the end of the road.
It's only like 5 picks. Yeah. That's like one a day or seven one a day or 7 days in a week.
That's more than 5 picks.
Huh?
I mean, 7 picks. Good.
So they seem like there's so much work to us.
Well, you know, like I'm not gonna say, but like there's pictures that like I'm just put nothing into it and it gets like mad love and then
I'm telling you,
like,
yeah.
Go out of my way for like it's like what? It's like whatever. And I'm like,
it's the name of the game, man.
Like, I suck. I cannot tell like what's what.
No, people want because the better it is, the more they hate, dude.
Yep. Or they just don't get me. It. You know, they see like simple stuff. They're like, I can do that. I like this.
Or you just didn't buy the likes that day.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that too.
You got caught slipping.
Short of cash. Short
well, Adrian,
cash.
Let's talk about what we saw this morning. Bob sent me a post of a guy who had obviously bought some likes that day.
That something's going on there.
He was testing out something, huh? You found that app?
Yeah, well.
He bought that caught slipping app.
So tell us, what did you see? Tell us about it. What was going on
there? I saw a person with a picture that had zero, or had two hashtags, I think. Right? And he's got like 200 followers. All his pictures had like, you know, 40, 50 likes. That's what it is.
But nothing spectacular. Just like somebody one, who just
and
got
the picture. The picture, and it was a shitty picture too. By the way,
yeah, it was really, really bad.
I'm not, not to be a dick, but it wasn't even like clear. It was like the other pictures were better. That shit had like 900 and something likes.
Within like a couple of minutes, you said.
Yeah, but it was, and he only has like people with millions of followers that don't put any hashtag. Those followers like those pictures.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? This guy has 200 followers. Where did those other 700 people see that picture?
Right. The bot people, dude.
That's what I was trying to figure out.
There's some fucking powerful apps out there that get snuck by and people use
them. Because, you see them in hashtags and stuff, but he had no hashtags.
He had no hashtags.
So the followers are going to be the ones that see this picture.
Unless he's got
the 200 of them.
He's got like 4,000 people just creeping on his page, just keeps doing the load thing.
He's got a lot of trolls, yeah.
I don't know. Maybe he just bought like the stuff today or something or whatever.
he'll have 50K by next week, and then he'll come up with his own website, and then he'll tell everybody how he's an expert in the field and that he deserves all the work because apparently this is work and not just for fun.
Right.
All right, so aside from that crazy...
Don't get caught.
That's like the first time like I've seen like
it's obvious. Like it's
like
super
that blatant. That blatant. Like, holy shit.
Well, I realized it later that somebody that we used to give a lot of shine to on this show, I realized it later that person's been buying everything the whole time. So it's fascinating that people do
he
this.
He goes
hand-to-hand.
It's
fucking fascinating.
Who is this? Can you name him?
No,
obviously not.
That's rude. But it's obvious. It's
can
obvious
you name
who these
them? He
are.
Says.
It's obvious who they are, right?
I don't know.
People who Ryan. Suddenly who show up, they've been around like a year, and suddenly they're at like 60K or some crazy shit. And
Ryan's
like, wait a minute.
Ryan's trying to start some shit.
Yeah, he's always trying to start some
shit. I'm trying to find. I'm trying to. Do I know this person?
What the fuck? What an asshole.
You're.
His name is Decomp Rob. It's Rob.
It's
Rob.
Right, very cold. You're very cold right now.
It's all Rob's fault.
Moving on.
Mr. Vanderwill. And Eric. You guys didn't know about Eric. He bought some followers tonight, too. That's why he's keeping that poker face.
My.
All right, so Ryan, let's break into your week, Mr. Instigator. So tell us about your pickups this week.
I did
tell
not
us what's going on. You received a package from Mr. Eric Plays there.
Yes. Thank you very much, Mr. Eric Plays. He sent me a bunch of very sexual items.
Ooh, we just kidnapped the baby.
And two balls.
Okay.
I sent him
two of those NBA basketballs that came with those figures. That's cool. And then what's that? What's that missile from? Is that the mother of all bombs that we dropped on Afghanistan this week?
It's a cock-shaped missile.
That's the failed missile from the North Korean Pyongyang missile launch.
Oh, the MOB?
No, that's not the mother of all bombs.
Oh no, that wasn't.
It's too small. No, America's bomb would be much larger. Our phallus that we drop on people is
America.
Much bigger. We dropped a giant dildo full of explosives on people.
And he gave me this Canadian Post mailbox.
Wow, look at that. And so it even says ATA on there. That's cool.
Yeah.
Ryan's like, I'm not going to shoot it from that angle.
Nope. Eric. It says Eric Plays.
Yeah.
So Eric, graffiti artisted. He went through and did the little hood rat. Graffiti artistic. I'm not going to call it tagging because it's not a tag.
Oh, he vandalized.
He tagged it.
He vandalized government property.
That right there, if that was like an actual thing on the street, you would say, oh shit, look, it's tagged up.
Oh shit.
Oh shit, somebody tagged tagged up the mailbox. That's right there. He tagged it up.
Eric did that because he's an anarchist.
Mm-hmm.
He's part of the ATA Alliance.
I used to do that shit back in the day, boys.
Damn.
No, really? You do it all big with all the colors.
Would you climb on the back of trains and do it on freeway passes and all that correct? Shit?
Big thick fucking markers and shit.
Hey, homie, hold me by my ankle so I can write my name on this shit, dog.
Boost me up, homes.
Boost me. Boost mobile.
And Eric gave me babies.
Oh, shit.
He gave you some babies.
With my balls and rocket, exactly. I gave him babies.
And nice. He gave me hush money for that.
Too. Oh, yeah?
Case of hush money, so right here.
Oh, that's cool. Ooh. A case of money? What's that from?
I don't know, Eric.
I just really wanted to give you that case is from some wrestling figure somewhere on the line.
Yo, these wrestling guys come with some cool fucking, I see them in the store. Yeah. They got cool props.
What about the money? Where'd that money come from?
The money came from Bodega Joe's.
Oh,
that's really cool.
Oh, damn.
He sells those?
That looks legit.
He was back in the day. I don't think he is anymore.
R.I.P. Bodega Joe. Yeah, it's really sad what happened to that guy. R.I.P.
He's doing photos.
Isn't he that guy that died?
He's still alive and kicking. No.
Oh, I thought he was one of those dudes that died.
Alex? He's not Alex.
I don't know. Some of these people just drop off like flies.
Oof.
I haven't heard from that guy in years.
Oof.
All right, so what else did we get? Oh, he sent you a monkey as well, a baby
gave me
monkey.
Chimpanzee yeah.
monkey.
Monkey on his back.
On his back.
On his back.
Put it on the
Ryan said that he was going to turn that into an earring and wear that over off of his right ear.
Not no, Prince Albert it.
Oh, you're going to Prince Albert it. Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Make it his foreskin.
It looks like the Outbreak Monkey.
The Outbreak Monkey.
The Outbreak Monkey was a macaque, not a chimpanzee. Jesus Christ, get your primate straight.
It's a little monkey, dude.
Suck macaque.
Suck
and
macaque.
A zorg.
I got that.
Oh, yeah.
What's that guy called?
That's Zorg. From that is story, Buzz zorg, Lightyear's yeah. enemy.
Emperor Zorg. He gave me that.
God, that looks like trash.
Throw
that,
throw that.
Eric was going to smash it into the ground, so he sent it.
I was hoping it would be in scale with your, I think you had the Reveltech.
Yeah.
Buzz and Woody.
Oh, he thought ahead. What a nice gentleman.
It's actually,
That thing looks like a vibrator with an evil costume on.
It is.
I don't know. It has spikes on the top, so.
Some people are into that shit.
It's a butt plug.
I mean, at least it's ribbed on the middle.
Why does he wear a dress?
He's an emperor.
It's a tunic. He's
poked around.
Classy.
He's classy. It's purple. He's royal. What's his name? Emperor Zorg?
Zurg.
Z-U-R-G. Zurg. No, I could use him as a, I guess...
Doorstop.
False perspective. Doorstop. I'll use a false perspective on him. Because he's supposed to be bigger than Buzz.
Okay.
Yeah. The Buzz is the Red Ball Tech one. It's actually a lot bigger than... Not a lot, but it's slightly bigger than this one. So okay. I have to use a false perspective. Thank you, though. Thank you very much, Eric.
Yeah, no problem, bud.
Very cool. So did you work on any shots this week? Did you give us any shout-outs or anything like that? Have you tried to tag ATA, or do your fingers just not work? Are you going to enable commenting on your feed ever again?
Can
I unfollow you?
He got caught.
He's all about he's all about his stories and theatrics.
Yeah.
Right. He got caught slipping this week?
I did. I accidentally... forgot to turn off my comments section on my photo.
No.
This is a shot that Mr. Jared helped me with.
Ooh.
So
he came over to your house?
He was jobbing it up.
He was trying to go lazy with it. Yeah. I was just shooting, I guess, like three figures with Deadpool shooting the... some Nendoroid, and then he told me to add this thing right here, and then add this guy right here. Put a kite on it.
Stop telling me what to fucking do.
I know.
Jesus Christ, he had you put a kite on it? I mean, I like the kite. It's really great.
Was, I was like, why are they... Because at first, it was just like two people standing in a field, and then there's Deadpool. I'm like, why the fuck
that
are these
sense.
People... I was like, why the fuck are these people here? I was like, you gotta put somebody like with a dog.
I like
or
the dog.
A kite
the dog's and... cute.
90...
Is that a Yorkie or a Lhasa
Apso?
I know. I'm trying to make Ryan better than you.
No, I'm saying, like, I'll start off with one thing, and I'm like, no, something's wrong, and then just keep adding just shit.
How come that person's blood is pink?
Because he's Asian. Come on.
You guys have pink blood?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's kind of pinkish, yeah.
Really? Ryan, that's a nice usage of your new Nendroid and your new in-scale grass, too.
Mm-hmm. My in-scale grass, yeah, huh? Did you buy it one? Did you buy one yet?
No, I didn't.
Did you buy it one?
Did you buy it?
Where is that from? Where'd you get that from?
Amazon. It's called Mini Grass.
You can get it off Wish, too.
Yeah. Where? If you're Amazon.
And what did you say?
Wish.
What's Wish?
Wish is an app.
I'm looking at you on the screen and like pointing at you like if you're, you know, like a buffet. Like, what'd you say?
Wish. Well, you were there.
That's what happens when you dab before every episode.
Right.
Although, at Wish, it's cheaper, right? Like $2, he said?
Yeah, you just gotta wait, though.
For two pieces. Well, you have to wait for at Amazon.
No, it was four pieces or... Yeah, I got 8 pieces for $4.
And what, they send you each one separately or something?
Right, probably, yeah. I just have to wait 3 months for it to come in.
They probably came from China, because my all of the ones that are available online are coming from China.
Mm-hmm.
So I ordered another six pieces.
Sex.
A sex doll.
And it still hasn't come. It's more than a month now. So
that's what's called mini grass?
Mini grass, yes. So they're 5x5, I believe, right? They're cut into 5x5.
I don't know. You're the one that has
guess.
Oh, yeah, you don't have it. That's right.
Duh. I don't know. Nobody else
yeah. And that's it. I didn't hear you.
I said it's a fun shot. Deadpool's a dick.
Oh yeah, yeah. That Jared helped me out with to make it really good. Because I can't do any better.
I mean, it is. This is definitely better than the shot you were gonna drop.
Oh yeah, yeah.
I'll say
that. No, definitely.
Much.
No. I. That's why. Thank you, and I appreciate your help, Mister.
I got ideas and shit.
You do, and then when I give you ideas, you don't take it.
I know. So
fuck you.
I know. He listens and to everything I say, and I'm always like, I like it like this, Brian.
I know. I was trying to help him out. Like, you can angle it. It's like, I like it. Shut up. Tried to help you out.
Yeah, I didn't.
He just doesn't want to retake shots.
That's what it is. That's what it is, yeah.
And it's a good shot, Ryan. I really like this. And good work, Jared, with the accessories and everything. It does give it a purpose.
I was trying to do a shot last night, but I couldn't find the props, so I figured, what the hell, I'm just going to make it into a story. It's not worth releasing.
Jesus Christ.
So I'm trying to make a social commentary about how Easter has become like more of a bunny, an Easter bunny stuff rather than Jesus.
Rather than Jesus?
Right. South Park
returning from the dead.
Yeah, because what I was trying to do, but I couldn't find the props, was I was trying to make him sit with a bunch of kids, like playing, trying to search for eggs while him like looking bored. But I couldn't find
There's no kids in the picture.
So that's why I didn't do it, because I couldn't find the props. Yeah, I didn't bother. Like, we'll just do this.
He did it way too late.
Did you just take like a stuffed animal and cut it all up and put that guy inside it?
That's from the Buffy line.
It's from the Buffy. The Anya Halloween.
Expensive now.
I've never seen that.
No, it's only I saw it recently for $30. But the problem is
that costume, that egg, that bunny costume.
Yeah, it's actually a lot smaller than any of the figures. This one I have to take apart the midsection so that I can actually fit him in it. Also, the arms won't fit into that costume as well, so I had to fub it.
Put the hands in.
Right. It's only about 5 inches, I believe, the actual figure or the actual costume.
Figures.
So it's a very nice, it's a very well done piece, though.
Mm-hmm.
Wolverine can fit in it. So
it's for sure like, meant for like actual, like 112, no?
Yeah. Well, yeah, kind of.
Almost G.I. Joe.
Yeah.
Oh, so like 118th.
Mm hmm. So it'd be like
interesting. Well, it's a cool shot. So we got Jesus in a bunny suit.
334. 334.
Numbers.
Well, that's my own Instagram.
Very sweet. Cool. All right, Jared, so the tables have turned.
It's now your turn. My glasses.
And everything you say, I'm going to talk over you. Because you're a mouth breather, you're a chip eater, and it's just not good. There he goes. He's a mouth breather.
That was to my nose.
Sometimes when I get high, I just like forget how to breathe.
You know, that was what you were doing on my week last week, which is fuck. It sounded like you were having a heart attack.
You know what was funny?
The diabetes was killing you.
Well, the funny part was I re-listened to the show and I went to the bathroom and like my iPad was in the living room and I'm like pissing and I can hear like breathing and I'm like, I stopped pissing and I'm like, is that breathing? And I piss a little bit and I'm like, I stop and I'm like, is that breathing? I'm like, I can't tell until I finished peeing. And then I went out there and I was like, oh, that was.
You got to stand back a little bit from the mic. You don't need to have it down your throat.
Jesus. Well, what do you guys listen to? You guys listen to the at Podbean or iTunes? Because like, I usually listen to YouTube. Yeah, and I can't. It's not as bad.
Which is weird because the YouTube is completely unedited and I actually isolate or I even everybody's microphone out when I do it on Podbean. So I level everything out, which is weird. So I would think that it would be less recognizable on the iTunes. So I don't know, whatever. Anyway, after, I don't know, it's been a while, I did receive the bootleg Ash figure from NECA. So the newer version.
Hear that, Randy? Look what he did.
This one is fucking better than this one. The normal one. The regular NECA one. Because, as you can see right here, if you guys are watching on YouTube. So here's the piece right here, right? That goes into this piece right here. The regular NECA one I had, the hole was fucked up, and it never, it falls right the fuck off. So I was always pissed off about that. And I was like, fuck, what am I gonna, I tried like gluing the rim of it, all this shit, never worked out. So I got the bootleg. The bootleg's super fucking legit. So thank you, whatever. Super bootleg.
Wow, that's crazy.
I picked up the...
Mine doesn't do that, though.
Well, I'm sure. I mean, I got Fox, so... Exactly. I got a 3A t-shirt. All by itself. You guys can see.
Nobody's dying on it.
These are cool. Very
nice.
So
you've had this guy for a while, huh? Yeah.
What guy?
You
this
don't
guy?
Shoot him enough, bro. I don't see.
I did when I first got him, but I bought him.
Is that the Mark custom action figure you just made? He's got cuffed
he's
pants
balding,
on.
So this is like Mark realizing. Well,
that's me, right?
That's Costanza.
You need to give him a beard.
I'll try.
And then I want the tattoos.
He's got He's got his own action figure. Where's yours? I saw yours on the motorcycle. Show that one.
Oh yeah, show that one. Everybody's seen that one. And then the jeans is something that I worked on. So those are real jeans.
Oh, that is real.
You made those?
I made these, yeah. So
out of what?
Out of real jeans.
Cut jeans. And then you just cut the shape and then sewed the size?
I didn't sew. Oh, I glued it. It's all
glued.
It's all fabric glue. So the back, it still looks kind of seamless, actually. Yeah.
But that's stuck on him forever now, though.
No. These come right off, dude. These come right the fuck off. Yeah,
like you gotta unglue everything, or do you just slide off?
The pants are glued, so not glued to him. They're only glued to themselves.
Yeah, but I'm saying like when you take it off, does it fall apart or it comes off like pants?
It comes off like pants.
It's glued onto the seam.
It's glued onto the seam. It's folded. It's folded basically.
What?
So hold on, let me take it apart. So if you take
what
the
seams,
off,
dude? He made that shit himself. There's no seams. He just cut that.
I mean, I cut it in a shape.
A mini tailor.
Right. I'm an Elizabeth Taylor, actually.
Oh. How many husbands have you had?
What's up? I want some pants for my ego. Let me get some volcano wash.
You want some?
Volcano wash.
What the hell is volcano?
I don't know.
That shit that they sell at Tommy Bahama?
Like the old school Edwins used to come in like volcano wash and I don't know what.
You don't want Jinkos?
Jinkos?
Jinkos.
I am surprised, Jared, you didn't give him gigantic baggy pants.
Why would I do that? That's mean.
Because those are in style now.
Like the hammer pants. Or skinny jeans. Give him some like lowrider skinny jeans.
Some lowrider skinny jeans. So yeah, give it a try.
So that'll only fit on a SH Figuarts?
Well, that's a Figma, actually. So that's real small. But those particular ones, well, yeah, the ones I made very small. But, I mean, you could technically make them in any size. The bigger the figure, the better it's going to be. So I wanted to see what a real jeans would look like on the smallest figure that I have, and it looks good.
I like
good.
To see what a real jeans looks like. That looks like a good real jeans.
Real jeans, bro. Very random is I had a $5 coupon at Toys R Us. So I went and Bandai in the girl section are making these marvelous figures. So it's basically a line for girls. There's two regular looking girls and then they have two costumed girls. I can't remember the name of the costume.
Bandai
girls.
Is that Bandai America?
These are Bandai America. She has double jointed legs. So she's got pretty decent articulation. I just think she looked good for if you did like an anime, obviously, like she'd be a white anime chick. Or if you did like
she's
a cartoon.
She's got blonde hair. She's got like a
right. So shirt she came underneath. She came with a nice camera. Cool. She came with a nice bag. So yeah.
It was an impulse buy.
It was. She was $5. You know, I was like, she's got good articulation. She's a chick. I'm totally all about it. Oh shit, it's in the other room. It's like a wine set. It came with like a wine bottle. There's a, you'll see it, a photo of it when we get to my week. But it's like a set where the wine like sits
it's like,
in the case.
Is it Japanese?
It's totally Japanese, yeah. And then it came with four like wine glasses. It was like $4, but I had to wait forever for it.
Yeah, they have those at Frankenstein's. They have a shitload of those.
Right.
Oh, it's probably the React one. Remint. Remint, I think that's a brand.
It's one of those.
I forget
like,
the name of it. They make a lot of like alcoholic stuff.
And then I was what the
holy shit?
That was very.
What
loud.
Was that?
I have no idea. Was
it from you or?
It was out in the hallway.
File cabinet stuff.
You should check it
maybe
out.
Maybe you should go take a look at what that was.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Right.
I
agree.
I don't have anything out there, so I don't care.
Dave?
Yeah, I hope not. Poor Dave.
Wait a minute. You don't care? What if it's a murderer?
Yeah, what if someone fucking fell? Yeah. Anybody else live there?
Probably a toy. Want to check your toys?
Do you have
be...
that thing where your eyes shake back and forth?
Probably.
I don't think so. Do they look like it?
It looked like it for a second. Like you had that thing where your eyes are moving like crazy back and forth.
Scary. I think
is he possessed by a demon, perhaps?
I think it's the reflection.
It's the glare. It's that glare.
All right, so I was talking with Bear Trap. Did a live thing. He sold some dickheads. He sold some figures. He had a the newest
who did?
Bear Trap. He had the newest NECA Jason for $10 with none of the accessories. I didn't want the accessories, so I bought it. Oh, it came with the grave, so he hooked it up with the grave. And then two of the Mezco figures from the Heroes line, the dad and the what the fuck is his name? I can't think of his name right now. But he's a suited body. So I have a couple of those now. Very super good deal, super cheap, very nice to him. So thank you. If I had the shout out button, I did the shout out. He should be on next week, so we'll try to interview him and ask him some dumb questions next week. I did notice on the Facebook for Amok Time, they apparently found like a case of these Elvira figures.
I ordered one, dude.
Hell yeah, from 2013. They're super expensive on eBay, so they had them available with free shipping for $40. Definitely had to pick that up. So I'm excited about that. Only other thing went on my week. I finally bought a copy of this movie. I had seen part of it before. But I had not seen all of it, and it is Roddy Piper did another movie in 1989 called Hell Goes to Frogtown. This movie is fucking awesome. Totally a fun-ass movie. Totally a very good, fun romp. And then I saw Green Room. It was okay. I could see why people like it, but...
I liked that one.
It was kind of boring.
I liked it.
Yeah, it wasn't terrible, but it wasn't amazing, so...
Green Room?
Green Room. All right, that's it. Let's get into my week.
All right, so let's break into Jared's week in Instagram. For those of you guys that are listening to the audio, tune in on your IG to Junior_Doom.
Oh.
Oh?
Oh, no. I guess you posted the new one.
Duh. I actually read those. Shit, man.
Ooh.
That turned out good.
Do I have to do this?
Dude, yeah. This shot is fucking sick.
Bunch of dead
So, hairs. Like what? Like these cards are all individually up there right now? Like they each have like a little
Jared
wire
threw.
On
them?
Yeah, threw them. Higher shutter speed.
Him. I totally threw them. Right? So yeah, this
and
is
they
a
all
shot
happen to
I did.
Face up.
This is a shot I did with, it's an extreme set in the background. I have two of the Mezco stuck in the middle with you, Reservoir Dog cop tied up. I have two of the Diamond Select Black Cat safes back there. I don't know what the top safe is from, and I think the bottom one's like a WWE one. I literally just got a shit ton of stands, and I put the fucking stands up, and I put the fucking cards all up, and then I took the shot.
So they each have like a little wire, like they're all up with
they're
little wires
like
right now.
They're all clear Figma stands. And then one of them, actually, I use the, if you have the Mezco Batman, he has a bunch of articulated pieces for his cape. So his cape can
Superman
hold up.
Too.
So that, the top part is a lot of those. Those are all kind of like bent in and they'll have all the, you know, stuck on there. So all you do is you take one shot with all of them in the frame. And then you remove all of them out and you don't move anybody. That's the trick, though, is to get them out
that's
without
the
moving
part.
Everybody. And then you take the shot without it, and then you blend the two of them together. So
tell
that's
us about how, the kit bash you
that's
did
how
with
you,
the Joker.
That's how you pros are doing this stuff like that? Because I'm just
super pros, bro.
I'm just scratching shit out. Say it again. How are you doing it?
So basically, you're going to take a photo with all of those stands in the picture, and then you... You know, make sure it's perfect. Make sure all your lighting, that's your final image of it. And then without moving the camera one bit, like you have to have a tripod for this. Has to be on a tripod. Have to not move it either. So I highly recommend you getting a remote to do this. So you don't bump the camera. So you're going to take the shot of every single piece in there. Like, things are going to obviously
all
be
the
in
cards.
The way. Yeah,
all the
with
cards
the,
are in
with
there
the
right
stands,
now.
With the stands up and everything. And then
but without
that,
the guy, without the figures, you're saying?
Everybody, no.
Everything no, everybody's,
in,
the,
everybody's
there.
In the shot. Everything's in the shot. And then the next shot, all you're doing is removing just the stands. Each one of the, so in the next shot, there's no cards in the shot whatsoever. And then you take those photos,
you layer
the,
it, and
you
then
layer
you
the one
delete.
On there.
And then,
the
you're,
stand,
and then
you
you're able, to, you're able
out.
To blend all that stuff out without
you don't even need to
him
blend.
In
you're just remove. You're just basically like, you're going to an app called like, we do. I can use PicMix on my iPad. And PicMix will just allow me to superimpose that, but then rub out the area that you don't want to be seen.
Damn, I gotta get like something bigger because my phone screen kills me too. I'm doing everything.
That's why
with
I did
the
phone
iPad.
Screen. And if you like, if you have a phone service or whatever, I know it's extra. But what you can do is if you're like, I think Sprint does it, but I know I do it with Verizon. I'm basically like loaning an iPad. So like I pay like $20 a month. Like I threw $200 down I think on it when I got it, and then I just pay like $20 a month extra on my phone bill.
iPads are not that expensive. They're like $200.
You can get one.
And you
could
do all this on there.
You're,
see a
you're paying all this money to rent an iPad?
And then you're not dogging on your phone, yeah. Because I these photos are too thick to be fucking with them on my phone, so I can't do that. So the iPad is definitely a better source for me to wax those on there. But yeah, and then this is just the DC collectibles. It's like a rubber shirt, basically. Sure. But you cut the middle of it, and then you can slap it on there. He doesn't have a lot of articulation with it on there, but I still think it looks cool. So.
And so he's playing 52 pickup with the stupid cops. Right.
And then there's that Austin Powers camera there with the lens removed.
Nice.
I thought it was his.
That's a great shot.
And I don't
know. Did you say Eric?
I don't know where the gun came from. Sorry.
Isn't that from the new Joker?
No.
That's a Kenner gun that came with the OG, like really old school Joker that had
probably,
a hat.
Probably, yeah.
Yeah, in the white box. Right?
I don't think it was in a white box. It's from like the 1980s.
Oh, no. I'm thinking of a different thing.
Next shot. But I like it. Oh, no.
All right, so we got the juice video.
Juice Weasel.
Play that shit.
Juice Weasel. So we got Jim Carrey from Saturday Night Live, dude.
He's obviously
fucking murdering. So he's making fun of
Jack O'Lane.
Oh, yeah. That's exactly like Jesus Christ.
I used to take my family on trips like this all the time. Yeah, what happened to him? You know what? I outlived them all. He's free of the power of the juice. All right, keep moving. Everybody's seen this. If you haven't seen Living Color, I feel bad for you. This is just another piece I made. It was just an image, you know, of the Toxic Avenger and his woman there. I just used some of the, you know, apps that I have and stuff and splashed that romantic song on there. Because I love you, Lloyd. And I love it when you comment on my stuff. So this was just an idea.
This is very cool, man.
Funny idea that I had. You know, I was obviously channeling my Berol Mirado. No. I love that bouquet.
This is what happened to Eric right here.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I know, I was preempting it. Right. Totally preempting it.
You foreshadowed. Jared's fucking pictures are the Mayan calendar. They're going to reveal all the fucking future to us.
What do you have to say, Eric? What do you have to say? Come on, Eric.
He's not saying anything.
So mad.
Rage. It's super fucking, you know, easy, but still I thought it was, you know, a fun shot. Obviously, Ryan was the only one that really got the double pun of it being Hellboy.
Who's this guy? Who's it supposed to be?
Who's this guy? Fucking some
that
dude.
Character. Banshee, like what character?
There's no, these are just supposed to be regular fucking people.
It kind of looks like Jeff Colbert.
I don't know who that is.
You know who that is?
No. That's his buddy from school.
That dude from WCW?
No. Bro, he's been in a bunch of like 80s movies. Bro, he's still like, he was in Sons of Anarchy too. He was for a while in Sons of Anarchy. Bro, he's in The Walking Dead, the guy that Daryl ran into and then killed him because one of them tried to bite off Rick's ear.
I know who you're talking about.
Rick bit that guy's ear off. That guy. It looks like that guy.
Yeah.
That's Jeff Colbert.
I wasn't going for that.
All right.
No, I'm just saying. Like, that's just that face looks like.
Fancy. I'm happy for Jeff that
got
he looks like that, too.
Got itchy and scratchy in the background. We got Chucky there. We got Pee-wee's golden version of his bike. Got an X-wing.
Golden version of Pee-wee's bike.
Got to be Pee-wee's bike, isn't it?
I got
and then
my
you just
custom,
wanted to use that shelf again. I like the Wolverine on there.
I got my custom posters over there too. So we got the
that shelf is dope too, bro.
I got two of those now. I just got two of those. I love those things. They're massive.
Are those Micro Machines, Jared?
Those are Dick Tracy Micro Machines. Yes.
That's right. Yeah.
So, I don't know. I just thought it was a fun shot. I like the expressions. Yep.
Super duper setup.
So, there it is again. That Hellboy is on a stand there. It's on a straight up stand. And then you take the two shots and then just you can wipe it right out.
See, I just do the Photoshop. Fixing with my finger, like just scratch it out.
Yeah, it's better. It's way better. You don't have that blurry, you know.
Yeah, I'm sure.
So I like it, but that's just the banshee head on his ass and just put some Figma hands on him.
Dope, dude.
You're not going to do that to yours, Mark?
Ooh. No.
So this is just sexy a staircase legs. That I got. So this is like the, I don't know, how does the multi work on Kill this, Bill? Ryan?
What happened?
Kill Bruce.
How does the multi work on this? Because this is just a video.
Oh.
Right.
So what is, where does the staircase come from? What company produced this?
I don't know. It's just, it's, it came in a box that told you that it had a base to it as well. So me and Ryan both went on these because we were both curious. We obviously had two different experiences.
Right there, like that angle actually looks like a...
It's hard.
Like real stairs in a real apartment.
For me to get that to work like that, I had to glue each piece to the base, which it made it seem like it was gonna snap all in there, but it fucking didn't. Like, I had to glue each one of the things to the base, and then each one of those pieces I had to like hold. I'm saying, like, each one of those I'm holding for like 5 minutes waiting for it to fucking glue, and my fingers were like, my fingers
were sticking. And if it falls over once, you're fucked.
I know. And it kept breaking because my fingers would like glue to it, and then I'd have to rip my finger off of it, and then fucking it would break. So that was a pain in the fucking ass to get this thing done. And obviously with that ugly ass fucking green, like, who the fuck is going to be like, oh, cool, I got these fucking green stairs.
People that are into 50s nostalgia.
I guess, yeah. So I had, obviously I
all these models are supposed to paint.
Right, so obviously I had to paint it, and I think it turned out good. I think it turned out rustic. So I'm happy with it. I did do a shot today that, you know, fucking Ryan critiqued. But what? I liked it. What?
Oh, the angle? Yeah.
Shut up. but I mean, the end result is, I mean, cool stairs. So. The next one is just what I just showed you guys.
Just a mock-up of...
Just a mock. This is one without even cuffs on, too. So this was before I left
Spider
the house.
Spider Jerusalem.
But you can see the wine set there, though. So that is the
is
wine set.
Is that Iga's body?
That is still Iga's body, yeah. His body's hard. But I like the cuffs, though.
Iga
like
wears it. Those fucking hardcore Kmart shoes.
Sure does wear those Kmart
those ones
shoes.
That people that work at, like, Burger King wear.
These are non-slip, all-black shoes that can get grease on them for 12 years straight and not fall apart.
Dude, no way! Those things last till, like, 2 months and they're gone. So these are just two different
Jared
versions.
Jared has a pair of pants right now with two little pairs of pants cut out of them.
Right.
They still wears.
Yep. So the first one
Jared's
was
really
like,
getting into skinny jeans. Look at these. They fit in the palm of your hand.
I know. So the first one I had the
hashtag
idea of
stretch
making, like,
life.
Two separate like sides that you could glue with the seams, but obviously that looks like shit because the sides all stick out. So the other idea I had was to like roll the fabric basically into itself and have like the seam almost in the middle.
Yeah.
So. You're supposed to put them together inside out and then you fucking then you roll them. Put them yeah.
I don't even know. I don't think they would hold with the glue I did. Maybe with the. If
so were those your? What jeans did you cut up to make those?
Just some old pair of jeans I ripped the crotch out of.
Look like volcano wash.
Volcano wash. The stone.
It's the blue note.
Acid wash.
Stone Wheezy, bro. Him in those fucking tight ass pants. So yeah,
keep going.
I love the fucking 3A clothes. Those are super legit. I got more of those coming in next week. So you know I had to do it. Fucking,
echo in the funny man.
I told he had to do fucking, this one's for Brody. Because I love that scene in the movie. When they take that. So if you guys don't follow me, this is a picture from Mallrats where Jay and Silent Bob are accosting the Easter Bunny because they are to believe that the Easter Bunny accosted Brody, which in fact it was Ben Affleck. So I had to swap out the hands. I think that's Iron Fist hand, honestly. I don't know why it worked, but the one's Iron Fist is...
Because they're pretty big.
They are pretty big, yeah.
Those Iron Fist hands are perfect.
For Diamond Select, too, I guess, so...
Yeah, they're great. I used them with the Nathan Drake, remember? With that NECA?
Oh, yeah. My NECA. So, easy shot, you know, but I just wanted... And this... In the movie, Easter hadn't actually happened yet, too. So I was kind of like
curious what day this movie actually took place on, but it did not take
place. Oh, just call Butterman. He'll tell you.
I know.
Probably on a Saturday.
Probably, because I know, because they were like, because they were in the movie, they were talking about how weird it was that the Easter Bunny like was already set up or something. I remember. So it wasn't on Easter, so that was what I was going with.
So about like a Saturday, 2 weeks before.
Yeah, probably. So easy shot, but I liked it.
It's nice. Dope. Yeah, I love it.
Nice foreground characters too. I always like that.
Yeah. The children.
Who is this kid by here?
Where?
Right on the bunny.
That's
pin.
Tracy Morgan.
That's Dexter Morgan.
close.
Mark was right about the Morgan. It's the three and three.
Tracy Morgan.
It's the three.
Hilarious.
Hey, when am I gonna get to sit down with an Easter Bunny?
It was the
Easter Bunny and pregnant.
Damn it.
It's the 3¾ version of him. Fuck, Jesus, you guys and your shitty jokes. All right, move along, sir. So I'm tired of waiting for my icons. It's time to shoot fucking ninjas.
This one was kind of, I think, racist, right?
Racist. This one, the caption was. Yeah.
It is.
Can you read the caption for us, Ryan?
He's like, I'm Asian. I had this little dick like this.
That's what he said. Read the caption, man.
Okay. Oh, you flower ready? No. You have a right a little bit real, girl, okay? I'll be ready.
What language
is
that?
I have to read a riddle bit
wronger. A riddle bit wronger. Just a riddle bit wronger. Well, I mean, the figure has this, like, pinchy. Like, I'm like, I have to do something with this whole, whole pinchy hand. So I'm like, you just have to wait a riddle bit wronger. And then you get your
eyes on how much my dick is.
I'm surprised nobody asked me where that bass is from.
This got no racist comment, but I put a fucking Chinese food on a fucking table.
Did I say? Oh, no, I made a pun. That's why.
He was too busy punning.
Look at the comments.
He reiki.
He reiki.
Rary Rice.
Eric finally comments on my photos.
Round eye up there.
Riri Rice.
Oh,
yeah, I'm an asshole. So, yeah, it's just the custom fucking Shiraway Inuit or whatever the fuck his name is from Star Wars. I have two. I accidentally have two of those fucking Crouching Eskimos. Tiger chicks. And then I have the good version of the fucking.
Do they look the same? Is that what you bought too?
That's right.
What's that? Is that Ninja Slayer? Is that what he's called?
That's the cheaper version of Ninja Slayer that I think is superior. Because he's more just ninja. The other one's kind of anime.
He's more ninja?
He's more ninja. He's more ninja-y.
Is that what Splinter told to Raphael? He's like, Raphael,
your leader is more ninja-y.
You're more ninja than the rest of your ninja. Ninja brother.
If you're going to be ninja, you better be ninja-y, bro.
Is this an extreme set background?
The extreme sets is in the foreground, yeah. And then nobody knows where that base is from.
No. We don't care, Jared. Just go on to the next
your aquarium?
No. It's a NECA piece, actually.
What? Which one?
Motley Crue.
Ryan, tell me what's wrong with this shot.
Oh, yeah. Somebody said that. They were like, Brian hit me up. He was like, yeah, I like that when Ryan like tells everybody what's wrong with their shots. Well, Ryan usually tells me what's, because I just sent
Ryan
it to him.
Ryan doesn't like that her elbow's cut off on the left, and he doesn't like that the dragon's head is cut off.
I don't want to be the asshole of the show. That's you, Mark.
Mm-hmm. No, that's you, Ryan.
The aperture is all wrong in the shot.
I'm the lovable, cuddly Mark.
Is it?
No. I'll do it to you because you asked for it. So.
Right. I send it right to him. So, I mean, yeah, either I fix it or I tell him to shut up.
So does he tell you, me reiki or me don't reiki? What does he say?
He always has. I rarely ever like send him anything and he's like, yep, this is good to go. It's always, he finds something. I mean, it's the same thing. Change. He sends me stuff too. I find stuff in his shots too. I mean, it's just easy.
Name of the game.
Kabuki, finally.
I love that figure too. I was gonna use two of the Kabukis, but I forgot that I placed the hands on one of them.
Our other chick passed out in the background.
they got high off that vape. That vape that's kicking off the floor. That's all it was. That's
fucking opium or that opium and shit.
He's just slapping opium on him. No big deal. So I just wanted to shoot this custom figure. Plus, I'm just tired of not shooting ninjas and martial arts stuff. So,
right.
Like, what about you? Are the king of posing, Jared?
What's that, Eric?
I mean, we can see here that this is probably the best pose that's ever been done in the history of action toy art.
Isn't there some figures that are ninjas that everybody's waiting on?
Yeah.
Yeah. Eric, what did you
say? Before you broke into this world and destroyed it.
Right.
Well, what figure? What is it? Because I've seen them come over, you know, and then like, oh shit, they're coming out finally, and then everyone's pissed that they don't come out.
Which
ones are they?
Articulated icons.
Oh, that's it right there.
That's it right there. Eric, what were you saying?
Oh, I was just gonna say, yeah, we've been like holding off on ninja shit for 2 years now.
Holding off, so I'm tired of it. I'm shooting what I got. I got another shot too. Like, we dropped.
They like some of them got, you know, like that little roof piece. Like, it's cool shit.
Oh yeah, it's super good shit. The funny thing is that I was talking to Ryan about how I've noticed that, like, when like me or Mark or other people just do these like ambiguous martial arts shots that don't necessarily have like a superhero or a main like character outside of Bruce Lee. Like, people don't give a fuck about them, really. And then I'm really curious like, what's going to happen when everybody gets these articulated icons, and they're just like, man, nobody comments on, like, when it's just
they'll get a million love.
It'll
get
a million love. Like, Daredevil.
A million love.
Put Mr. Miyagi in the dojo.
Right, like, when I get these, I'm not going to do, like, Marvel mixed up. I was just going to do fucking ninjas being ninjas doing ninja shit.
But that's what's going to happen.
Ninja.
You don't want to... You don't want to cross genres?
Not really, no. I wasn't.
I'm going to do American Ninja. I'm going to do Bloodsport
shots.
I mean,
I did want to do the Tick, though, because the Tick totally fights black ninjas, and I got three racist black ninjas, so that'll be
fun. I think most shots that we will see is the Hand versus Daredevil. I think that's what everyone's
going to
be.
What are everybody going to do with their black ninjas then? Oh, that won't be movie ones because they're black in the movie?
Don't they have the Hand? Don't they have like the black version too?
In the show, yeah.
No, they.
And white.
No,
anyway,
white.
Keep going.
That's stupid.
Pop-off, man.
Oh, so this is a shot of Jared in action on his hog.
Super action, dude.
Oh yeah, look.
That's Jared in the background.
Yeah.
Do you guys get a lot of potholes in California?
There is in Denver.
Like
a big issue. It's a big issue here. Like, whenever someone's like running for office or whatever, like, that's like we're gonna fix
the
fucking
potholes.
Really?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
And then they never fill the potholes, and they just give you guys more pot.
Mm-hmm. They'll fill them holes.
In the holes.
So yeah, that's the first thing you notice when, you know, you're riding something like that is fucking potholes suck dick. So. Luckily I have back pegs so I can like stand up, which is eases the burden of the potholes. Yeah, exactly. So I just got this moped, and you know, I just made this slighted kitbash figure ish thing, so I just thought I'd do the shot, and obviously it worked with me riding the hog right next to him, so I think it's a fun
hog.
Shot.
It's a ruckus. Let's not get ahead of ourselves.
I meant the other one. He's riding a hog on the right.
Yeah, but you made yourself there. So what are you trying
to?
You're trying to sell a false image. Next thing
we
know, you're
going
to tell everybody you joined a biker gang.
I could.
Jared's going to be like, so guys, I'm a. I'm currently getting patched in with the Sons of Anarchy.
say Satan's messengers.
I hate you guys.
That's the fucking that's the gang.
It's like, that's like the you gang see, you guys see this? This is legit. This is legit as fuck.
The movie with Charlie Sheen where he goes on the cover as a biker.
Yeah.
Oh god.
That's the name of the gang. Satan.
What about
messengers.
Stone Cold? That's a good one.
Oh, that's another biker one.
It's a good movie.
So yeah, easy shot. I took it. No big deal.
Quit showing off. So here
we got Steve Carell getting held up.
What am
by
I showing
Greg
off
the
there?
The fact that you have this figure and I still don't.
Oh, you don't have Brick?
No.
I love this.
I just got him. I just got him the other day, actually.
I love this Brick. He's all surprised.
I need him MOC though.
Oh, icy.
Why?
You're like, because I'm not opening him. I just want to collect the set. He was looking for this last year at the con.
Oh,
he was
maybe
walking
this
around
time.
Looking for this.
I mean, I could just like pull the trigger and buy it online, but
he's about ready to pull the
trigger. I got it for $10.
He's cheap now.
It's
yeah.
like 50 Canadian.
Damn.
No, it's not.
So just wanted to do a fun Easter shot of like a
they
fucking.
Use pesos now.
What's the dog from?
The what? That's the from dog? The Osbournes.
That's Kelly Osbourne?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, I have a couple of the, they're very, the figures are very caricature, but that dog is perfect. And in his mouth, he's got like a.
That's Kelly Osbourne. It's before all the plastic surgery.
Right. You can like squeeze part of the dog and the thing will like kind of come out. I don't know if it's like goo or a ball or what it is, but it moves.
I think I got it right here. Let me see if I can squeeze it for the camera.
Squeezing for the camera.
What happens is it throws up Jack Osbourne.
Can you see it?
Yeah, see, that's Jack coming out.
You guys see it?
That's really cool.
Yeah.
So I love you it. Squeeze it and it fucking comes out. But I love the dog, so I think I bought the set just so I could get the dog.
I had a little keychain like that, and you'd squeeze it and it would come out his ass like a little.
Right.
It was like shitting. Like a little.
So what, you know where this bunny's from then?
Where that's from? No.
You guys don't ask where the bunny's from, but you want to know where the fucking dog's from?
No, because you told us before.
What's the bunny
looks
from?
It's like a 3A bunny.
No, it's
You don't even know.
You told us before. Yeah, then on the show, you told us before. That's
yeah, and you don't remember, and you have a good memory, yep. So.
Yeah. No, maybe I just don't care.
That too.
So, where is this from? Where is this from?
Like, you even care.
No, I care.
It's a NECA figure.
Uh-huh. But what series franchise?
Nightmare Before Christmas.
Really?
Comes with the guy with the fucking axe in his head. He's like an accessory to that figure.
NECA made one?
Yeah. Nope, my NECA. All right, move along.
Next photo. Next, one more.
Wait, I do have one question on that last photo, though. Is that?
Oh, shit.
The bunnies on the background wall, is that Photoshop, or did you just?
That's Photoshop.
That actual wallpaper.
No, it's Photoshop.
Okay. Nice.
Super. Oh, and the park bench is.
He was going to ask you where you got the wallpaper.
Yeah, that too.
It's like, where did you get that cute wallpaper?
I want a bedroom.
So I was channeling my Asian, you know, ness, I guess, or my Berol Mirado ness, or whatever you want to call it.
This guy's a funny guy, bro.
This guy's a funny guy. So,
these two Asians have like this white redhead kid.
Yeah, they have a ginger baby. So Iga Shira and Pinky Brewster have a ginger baby.
Oh, I mean, there's no. I mean, that they're not necessarily saying that's their baby.
They're just pointing out what's
going
on.
They're just like, holy shit, we gotta be taping this shit.
The baby could be adopted.
Yeah, like we don't even know if those two are together.
I don't think. I mean, he's bald.
They could just be people walking the mall.
They're just people walking, bro.
They're clearly together. They're both Asian.
They're both Asian. She's Mexican. Did you see her fucking straps? She's a cholo. She's super cholo.
You mean a chola?
She's choly. So
Zero.
I was trying to come up with a concept of a baby being able to pee in the bunny's face, just because I thought that would be funny. So yeah.
But you thought wrong, Jared. This offends this offends the toy community, and we're gonna have to boycott
the
bunny nuts for having
bunny,
humor.
The bunny loving community.
The bunny loving.
You just pissed all over the bunny loving community.
Oh, do you know how many furries right now are up in arms? They're boycotting your restaurant. They're trying to get you fired from your job.
super fire.
I thought the bunny was biting the umbilical cord.
That too. That
would have been awesome. You should do that.
All right, Mark.
You should
do
like a Surgeon Freddy and Surgeon Bunny.
Insurgents?
And then, yeah, and then they're like he's biting through the umbilical cord with his bunny teeth.
All right, Mark. What's up with you?
All right, so my week, I had Rob over. He came over on Monday, and we hung out for quite a few hours, and we ended up taking a whole bunch of toy photos. He left me with some awesome fucking figures to still shoot. I did a shot already. I released one. We'll get to that when we get to my week. But do you guys know what this is from? I know it's supposed to be Satan.
Yeah.
I think he said Diamond Select.
It's not Diamond Select. It's It's from a series. That's the most expensive one in the line. It's
2008, and it says Chaos Comics.
Yeah. It's, I can't think of the name of the line. It came out.
I have no
idea. Bass figures, though.
It's fucking gigantic and incredible. And it has, like, rooted hair on it, which is pretty cool. So that made some good effects for that photo I did. It went perfect with the Illumin ATA, Ruins diorama that I set up, and then Rob took a bunch of shots there too. So we set some stuff up with like little Jason. We did some shots. We did just a bunch of stuff, and pretty cool, man. And then yeah, he even brought over that pit as well. I finally got to see that thing in person. It was fucking dope, dude.
Oh, Rob's got it.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, he's got that pit. So I'm just gonna actually get that from him. So what's the kid's name? Max.
Timmy.
Max.
I'm thinking of that other Max guy.
I need to get Timmy in the pit,
so I'm going to try to take some photos of that. And then Jared just walked away from the Action Twitter podcast because his bladder filled up and he can't hang the whole time. I can't either.
He says Timmy.
Oh, he's getting a bag of chips. Is that you get the chips, Jared?
Shut up. No, I didn't get chips. It's something else just to make as much noise, though.
Momo.
Is that your bag of drugs?
Yeah.
Bag of drugs and figures. You're actually a real-life drug dealer in your community.
Yeah, these legs, though. God damn it, Nekka.
Oh. He's Lieutenant Danning.
Right.
Get
that dirt fast, too.
So, yeah. That's pretty much all the toy anything that I did this week altogether. I didn't shoot anything after that. I've been busy working on other stuff and hanging out with my wife. Got some time off.
That's fair.
But I did see some shows, so I got some stuff to recommend. Jared's talked about Romeo and Juliet
forever.
For a long time.
That's like
so I finally got a chance to take a look at that. Not my favorite of the Troma films. No, I could not sit through that. I'd turn it off.
No way.
It was just awful.
Really?
If they didn't have tits every once in a while, I couldn't have even got through the first 10 minutes.
Oh, my God. I could watch that movie, like, over and over again.
There was
That's what happens that with your parents or cousins. I mean, I can't fucking watch that show. This is ridiculous. It's just, I can't do it. I watched Citizen Toxie, though, and I can sit through that. I love Citizen Toxie.
Why do you? Really?
Here's what I did see. It's been out for quite a while. Welcome to the Jungle with Jean-Claude Van Damme and Rob Riggle.
Finally.
That was fucking hilarious.
Well, you see that on? Is that Netflix?
I think it's on Netflix or Amazon. I can't remember.
It's on one of the Zons.
Yeah, it's one of those things. So, super funny. Super funny. Welcome to the Jungle. That's on I think it's on Netflix. This other thing that was on Netflix is called Frat Star. Have any of you guys seen this yet?
Mm-mm.
No.
Take a look at Frat Star. So apparently, do you know who that Fuck Jerry guy? He has like an Instagram feed where it's just all memes. He like rips them off of people. Somehow he was able to be the executive producer on this. And it's like a really dark sort of a comedy, I guess, about like what is life like trying to get in these like elite school fraternities.
Really?
And it's just like sex and drugs the whole movie. It's fucking gnarly.
Really?
I've seen Pop Star. That one's funny.
Yeah, this one's called Frat Star. They go out there with this. I mean, there's a lot of. It wasn't great. But it was an interesting watch and really hot chicks in it.
Nice.
The other thing I got into recently, which I've heard people talking about forever and seeing how good it was, but you only have so many hours in the day. But I finally got a chance to catch up. I'm like five episodes deep of Son of Zorn. Have you guys been watching that?
Oh, yeah. Brian made that custom, too.
That's right. Yeah, he made a custom of it. It's fantastic. It's really, really, really funny.
Really? Really?
So it's like basically like Roger Rabbit. Like, you know how there's the juxtaposition between a cartoon and then the humans? So they do this on Son of Zorn, and they completely pull it off. The chick that was Larry David's wife on Curb Your Enthusiasm, the blonde chick, she's on it. And she plays Zorn's ex-wife, and Zorn is basically He-Man. He's like this barbarian who like went to like – I don't know. It's fucking weird, dude. I can't even explain it. You guys got to watch that. I would really check that. Have you seen that, Ryan?
I've seen it, yeah. It's okay.
It's okay.
I mean, it's a the jokes can be a little bit cliche, that's why. But it's okay.
I mean, my favorite thing was when he's like, "Son, I'm sorry I've been absent in your life. I want to make up this time for you. And I got you a new ride." And they go out in the fucking driveway, and they call it a Death Falcon or something. And it's like a gigantic or a Death Hawk. And it's this gigantic fucking hawk. And it has like a mask on, and he wants his son to ride it, and his son gets on it, and he's like, "Come on, Mom." And then he kills it, like, in front of everybody, because they tell him his son can't have it. He, like, brutally stabs it on the driveway. Did I watch you guys? Son of Zorn. Really weird. All right, so the other thing I watched was I saw a couple things in the last couple of days. Event Horizon is on Amazon as well. Good. And if you guys haven't seen Event Horizon,
you suck.
I fucking love that movie. So, I know Jared's seen it. I'm sure Eric's seen it.
Unfollow me.
That's like one of the best sci-fis of all time.
So good.
Really good horror sci-fi.
That's the one with Fishburne, no?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Or Morgan Freeman.
Prequel to Jurassic Park.
Yeah.
Hello. Jesus Christ, what the fuck happened?
What?
Are you guys there?
Yeah, what happened?
I don't know. Like, the screen froze for a while, and you guys were making fucking weird faces. Like,
you were fine with us.
Like, all stretching out.
It's you.
What's going on. It's probably that ghost that knocked over everything in your fucking house, and then now he's here haunting me.
I know what happened.
What happened?
I was talking about Event Horizon.
Mm-hmm. I don't know what Jared was saying.
Have you seen that yet, Ryan?
I've seen it, yeah. I saw it in the theaters. Yeah, I saw it in theaters.
Right? Ryan's old.
20 years ago.
Yeah,
20 years ago. Yeah.
It's fresh in his head. Let's talk about it.
I want to watch The Mangler.
It's such a fucking good movie, though.
You guys remember The Mangler?
I gotta watch it.
I mean, I wish it was scary, but it wasn't. But I like it.
Yeah, it's not that scary. Like, it's an entertaining movie.
It's just a good movie.
It is.
Yeah.
It's very Hellraiser in space.
Sort of, yeah. It's cool. I really liked it. I had seen that movie. I saw it in the theaters, and then I watched it a bunch of times as a teenager. I had it on VHS. And then this is the first time I've watched it as an adult with a different perspective. And I was like, fuck, that movie.
I watched that movie, like, probably too much.
What have you seen on me?
Liberate.
Anybody see that Life one that was in the theater?
Not yet, no.
Not yet. I'm going to go see that. It's still on my list. And if you guys are interested in smoking something and just calming the fuck down some nights because we get too invested in how fucking fast-paced life is and our phones and all the crazy shit going on and the colorful flashy lights, they have Bob Ross now on Netflix. I don't know if you guys have seen
that. Nice, yeah, I did see
that. Have you been watching it?
No.
Dude, it's so relaxing to watch before you go to bed.
Before you go to bed.
Dude,
Ryan.
I've been sleeping like a
the painter. Baby. That's the painter guy.
The painter, yeah.
Yeah, that painter. Yeah, the painter always paints landscapes. He's just like the calmest, chillest dude ever.
The Froey Picasso, that thing.
Yeah, that dude.
The Froey Picasso.
He's the best, dude.
He's the bad motherfucker.
Yeah, so you guys, man, if you need to relax, put that on. Also, it's inspiring me to paint, so I'm gonna go pick up some.
Mark the artist.
Start painting some happy trees.
Are you going to start painting landscapes?
I don't know. Ryan, that's not a real baby. You don't have to do all that effort.
He's swaddling.
Nothing to nobody. He's swaddling right now, the baby.
So there's the coffin.
Fucking Beryl's dying now.
He's dying.
Oh my god.
Yeah, that's pretty much all I've checked out this week. That's all I have to recommend. Expect some more shots coming soon because I'm getting inspired just from talking to you guys. I got to shoot some stuff tonight.
All right, bro. Oh, by the Jared stole
my fog.
What'd I do?
You stole my idea.
For?
The peeing.
Oh, bro, I know. I already knew that.
Stole my idea.
I know. You mad?
Okay, so let's go to my week in Instagram.
You mad, bro?
Is that where it started? What was the photo before that?
Oh, that's the Mama June.
We
did we show that one?
Yeah,
we did. Yeah.
All right. So if you guys are tuning
right?
in to our feed on audio, on iTunes, Stitcher, Podbean, go ahead. If you want to follow along, we're going to cover my week now. So it's marked _for_death. So, yeah, this is just a little meme I made, and this is just for all those lovers, like Swiss cheese and all those guys that love us. And,
I like Swiss cheese.
What?
So I like Swiss cheese.
He's asking, like, so this guy's like, obviously he's out getting pampered, right? He's at the salon, right?
What's with that ABBA, what? What's going on down there?
That's the Mama June, the Mama June treatment.
He's getting the Mama June treatment. She's taking care of a fucking blackhead on his nose.
No. It says ABBA what down there?
Abra Cadabra.
Why does it say that?
Tattoo. He reps that shit right there.
He reps that shit.
That's what Bruce Willis says. Abra Cadabra, yeah. Motherfucker.
Exactly.
And then he also got a neck tat, that sweet ass fucking neck tat he got that says crunchy because his fucking shit is straight up icy cold stunner work, you know what I'm saying?
Icy cold stunner work.
Well, it's and also you don't get a fucking badass neck like that unless you've been eating some fucking crunchies, you know what I'm saying? Some
crunchies.
Yeah, he likes those bags of chips.
What was this like for some movie or something?
This is from Legion, which I just started watching on FX.
Okay. How was that, sir?
I'm impressed by the. I only saw the first episode. I just started last night. That was the other thing I forgot to tell you guys. I'm getting into it.
Wasn't there a movie? I saw a movie. Wasn't it a movie Legion?
Yeah, it was.
It's on.
That's what the series. The series is based on that same storyline of the movie.
It's part of the same universe. Yeah.
Mark's just lying to you. He's just saying things. He's shooting things out of his mouth.
It's from the X-Men, Beryl.
X-Men universe. Yeah. It's about mutants and shit. All right, so what is he saying here? You got to pan up. I don't know why we're so zoomed into it. So it says, so I titled it, We Love Our Fanboys. It says, have you heard of AT&T Dreadnoughts?
Nope.
I hate them.
Look at Eric.
We love our fanboys. That's a Dick Doc Dick 742.
What do you have to say, Eric?
Nothing.
Are you going to shit on this, Ryan?
Oh, no, like Eric, since, you know, he disappears whenever he does not talk.
He disappears.
So what do you think of this, Eric? I mean, this is a meme I made, and it was just to make you guys laugh. I hope that the 67 people that actually looked at it.
67 people. No. A million people looked at it.
All you need is really one thing.
67 people were comfortable enough to hit the like button.
I got a lot of DMs about it.
Nice.
That was nice. Well, yeah, that was that's my own Photoshop tattoo work there.
That's your whole week right there?
Abracadabra.
That's your whole week?
I keep seeing, like, you know, like the heart empty. And I'm like, shit, I could have sworn I saw this, but this is
We're
not my
We're spending a lot of time on
my
this.
Thing.
Oh, that's me.
Ryan's fault. It's okay though. It's all right. All right, so let's go to the next post. So that's just a meme. It's another.
Oh, yeah, I think I commented on this.
Oh, more memes.
All right, so already
I'm trying to scroll and it doesn't scroll.
We were talking last week about Jared thought that that roommate killing Ricardo Medina, the former 2002 Power Ranger, he thought that he had recently killed somebody. I said, no, it happened a while ago. And so this is actually the Power Ranger roommate killing kit. So I just wanted to find if they were selling anything like this because we want to know what they're selling to our children. So this is a Power Ranger with the Buffy the Vampire Slayer kit apparently in the back of his car. And he's got a fucking 45 he's pointing at the camera. And this is to protect the innocent, so I put some ATA podcast stamp over his
the
eyes.
Innocent.
Yeah, and so it says here, never forget
like
the 2002.
Or it's not Mark Furman. I'm thinking of Cato Kaelin.
Cato Kaelin, yeah.
I don't know why I got Mark 2002
Ranger Ricardo Medina's proof that the Power Rangers are dangerous to our fragile society. You can't trust irresponsible morphin teens with building-sized megazords to wield so much power. The question is, how many more roommates must die before this administration puts a stop to these colorful ninjas?
Mark's taking his memes seriously lately.
I'm a social justice warrior now, guys.
I know.
He's a memer.
Yeah.
What do you mean? What do you mean?
What do you mean?
I mean, you know what I mean. It's a Power Rangers roommate killing kit.
Mm-hmm. NBD.
I see what you mean.
You know what I mean?
Oh, he remembers.
All right, next picture. This is stupid.
This is stupid.
I know what you mean.
All I'm trying to do is make you fucking idiots laugh. All right, so this is This is the Lord Xavier himself.
Satan, our savior.
He's still hanging on that jungle.
That's Aleister Crowley behind him.
Mr. Crowley.
Bringing him to life in the jungle. Because of course he'd be down there, because that's where all the plants are. Where the Illuminati have risen from the flames.
This is a spicy peanut.
So I shot this with Rob at the place, and
the place
just went.
What place?
So Ryan, what's wrong with this?
Yeah.
Where does he begin?
I'm gonna start from the left or from the right.
Tacos from the left or the right?
Is he not gonna answer?
Did you really want me to get
he's
into
like,
it?
He's like, you want he's like, you want me to give you the good or the bad?
Yeah.
You want me to butter you up or sweeten you up?
The good thing is, there's no good thing.
That because you're super religious and it's against your tribal beliefs to actually
smoke,
even
bro?
Acknowledge the devil?
Where's the smoke, bro?
There's smoke.
There's smoke in the back.
No.
Should put it in the foreground. All the grounds.
What?
You should put it in all the grounds.
I have other shots of it in the foreground, but sometimes, you know, when you first burst into flames, there's no smoke right away. He just appeared. He's the fucking devil.
Yeah.
He just poof.
He manipulates fire himself. You think he's going to have to cough on some smoke?
Poof. Ryan's not answering that question, by the way. He's scapegoating.
I am. I can't dog on him for a second.
He thinks Mark's gonna like go off on him one of these days for critiquing his photo.
Oh, you know what I saw today too? Out of the furnace.
Great transition.
Mark loves it when people interrupt his week. How was it? Good.
Yeah.
All right, so that's a terrible photo. It got like 11 likes. So Ryan
did it.
He can't acknowledge it because it's the devil. He thinks the devil.
He's got 300.
Including Ryan.
Including Ryan.
I like it. Right there, see?
Nah, that's not a real like, though.
Mark, what do you think you could have done better?
There you go.
What do I think I could have done better? I wish I could have really conjured a demon. I tried. I killed some fucking goats and chickens.
Oh, my God.
The Slender Man.
Dude, I was trying to conjure so many demons to make this actually work, and just, you know.
The only
what it really is those flames are not that good, is what it is.
Blame it on the flame.
You just gotta light it, right?
Mark, demons only appear for politicians.
Uh-huh. You should have put
that?
Trump in there.
Oh, I don't have that figure. I need to get that.
You need it. These guys could hang out.
So you guys just really hate this. This is terrible, huh?
I think it's fine.
He has any critique, nothing good,
I
bad.
I think it's fine, but then again, I can't tell shit for shit, apparently, because I don't know what people are going to like.
You don't know what shit for shit, he says.
But bro, I mean, it looks good.
It's a dope figure.
Somebody just farted?
That was like a duck. That was like Affleck.
The smoke. He's got his dope set up there.
Ryan farted on, fucking... on. That was what he's telling us. What he thought of it.
He farted on.
It's all right, though. It's okay. All right, so next picture. That's a terrible photo, so we know. Okay, next crappy photo.
Garbage.
Okay.
More garbage.
This is in, it was in the toy store that that Eric was in the other day.
That's a fingerboard ramp. Garbage. That's, it's actually
garbage.
Furniture.
You love those stories.
All right, keep going.
It's keep going, ramps, he always. Says.
Ooh, a ramp.
Morrissey.
Oh, what's that? Here's another ramp. Here's another good. This is the best ramp in L.A.
Best ramp.
So we got Moss.
And this is... everybody skates.
Boom. Mostly. Tell me that ramp is fucking dope. Yeah. Fuck you guys.
Where is that? That's like in the back of somebody's house? Or
there ain't no ramp. That's a pool.
Yeah, yeah. But it's like wooded out, too. That's dope.
Yeah, it's all made of wood. It's deep.
Oh, it's in the back of a skate shop?
Yeah.
Nice.
But it's the rain. We had like rain for since like November, and it just
rained. And that fills up like a pool when it rains, or it drains.
Dude,
out
the
from
thing there? Has squishy spots. You got to watch out for all these traps.
Squishy.
Every so often, like a panel will come up, and you'll just eat shit.
Really?
Oh, dude, yeah. We skated all day, like 5 hours.
But they don't. There's no like little holes like for water like to drain if it does like rain there.
No,
like,
dude, the rain just sat on that shit, and then it just had to air dry.
Damn.
Yeah.
Shit.
We'll replace the panels. But if you look in that image, you can see there's like a hole in one spot, like in one of the pockets. But I learned how to air from one corner to the other. If you see those corners in the at the end of the video, that's like maybe 12 feet, I think. So like the corners on that side. So from the right side to the left, I can air from there to there. I put up a shot of that. All right, so keep going.
Yeah, I was going to say, I saw that somewhere.
Right, so this is the other shot I worked on. I worked on this on Wednesday. So this is the Toxic Avenger. This is the best I could do with a fucking background. I used the monitor, of course. But I threw some stuff in the foreground and just threw Toxie in there because it's Rob's Toxic Avenger. I got to give it back to him. I was like, I'm going to shoot. I just need one shot.
And then he's got to
so
send
this
it to
is
me.
The one I wanted to do. So it's just a static figure. I had to fuck with the mop, though, to get it to hang properly.
Fuck that mop.
You don't like that one?
No, I'm just joking. It's a good mob.
And then, I just threw in some like props in the foreground, like some other barrels, like drums that I had. And then there we go. That's the future. Toxic waste.
And that photo got no love.
No. It has 58 likes.
I can't see it.
God damn. Wow. You should have bought some.
You should buy some.
I know someone you could talk to.
Yeah, let me get that guy's page. Let's DM that feller. So I did a green light shining off of him because it's kind of like that toxic waste is like glowing, you know,
for
that
sure.
He's standing in. So I kind of tried to do that like it was glowing like up from the bottom of, I don't know. I know
like,
it looked terrible.
I don't know.
It's like washed out with the sky, but that's the only sky. The sky actually was washed out in the image, so that was like the best
totally.
I could do. So I just made it super bright.
I mean, I don't want to make you feel bad, like you completely ripped off my shot, but I mean, you completely ripped off my
shot. Did you use that same background?
Close. You don't remember the shot? I'm gonna have to break.
Oh,
it
what? What did he rip? What did he rip off the Toxic Avenger at a dump site?
Exactly. Yes.
Exactly.
Get the fuck out of here. Exactly. So out of character for him.
That's kind of what he does.
That's what he does. Yeah. It is this same figure too. I didn't have a custom at this time.
Is that really what it is? It's really
funny. I mean, if you use the same background, it's a different story. But you know, it's what this guy does.
That's what he does.
I'm gonna have to YouTube how to tie a noose.
Stop.
Didn't you learn that from the military?
Yeah, no doubt.
I was in the Navy.
How about the Boy Scouts?
Boy Scouts!
My parents didn't want me to be touched.
How about elementary?
Dear Watson?
Nope.
P.E. and shit.
You learned how to tie knots in P.E.? What, are you going to P.E. with fucking pirates?
No, we never played fucking tetherball and had to tie a fucking...
Save you on a windstorm. He went to fucking kindergarten with Popeye.
With Popeye.
All right. All right, so this photo's terrible. I think that's the last one for the week.
I'm still trying to find mine.
Everything about it.
No. No.
It's like, no, they're good. I swear.
I don't hate it.
Which one do you like better, the toxic one or the Satan?
Oh.
Yeah.
You won't say.
It's a tough one. It's a tough one.
They're photos.
Oh, here it is.
What's wrong with the Satan?
Huh? Nothing.
I don't think anything's wrong with it.
Oh, yeah. See. Oh,
I shot
that
with a different lens because I had to pan way back for that.
Stole my idea.
And I wanted to get some of the foreground in that. That's why I went for that. But
I
maybe
like
it's
the
angle is bad.
I didn't do the foreground in mine, so you got me there. I mean, it's there, but you don't see the floor. You don't actually see the floor.
Well, remember the shots that I'm doing, too. That was backlit with that Toxie because that has a fucking monitor there.
Right.
And
Ryan must have lied to me about that one being good too.
What?
Well, he didn't say it was good. He just said intoxicating. He just tried to be funny.
Right. I know why Ryan. I get why he won't acknowledge the Satan thing because he's afraid because he believes in some fucking black magic shit.
Right.
And then
I don't know we're the mom to these kids.
We ain't even got time for figures. We gotta wrap it up.
Wrap it up, B.
Wrap it up, B.
Let's break into figures that want to be made this week. Let's get this fucking shit show on the road. This is the worst podcast. Jesus Christ. All right, Eric.
No, I said we don't have time. I literally just said we don't have time. We got to wrap it up.
Oh, you said you don't have time.
No time.
All right. Well, fuck the figures we want to be made this week. Jared's calling a quits.
Damn, he's got a lot of
masturbate because he just discovered chat.
No, it's complicated to mix stuff when it's longer than 3 hours, and we're at 2 hours and 50 minutes.
Ooh.
I'm trying to save myself an extra fucking 40 minutes of editing. That's all.
Wrap it up,
just talk 14 minutes less then.
You! You and your quibs. All right, well, thank you guys for tuning in to this Easter spectacular. We will see you guys later on in the week as we will be doing a 420 podcast as well. So definitely
be worse than
tune
this one.
In.
Trust us.
Way worse. So, Beryl, if you're able to do the 420
episode.
If you're able to do the 420 episode with us, join us. You have to watch Evil Bong on 420 in the morning. So watch that, and then we'll talk about it. And also
Evil Bong?
Evil Bong.
Why, is it on at that time in the morning?
It'll be on, yeah, early in the morning.
Huh?
Super early on 420. Like, they're dropping it.
Is there a channel showing it at that time?
Yeah, we're waking up at 4 a.m. That's call time. And then 420, we're starting Evil Bong and we're starting smoking at that time.
Okay, but what's this Evil Bong you say? I have not seen this. Where would I see this?
You've never seen any of the Evil Bong movies from Full Moon?
Oh, no, I haven't.
Dude, you got a really fun night ahead of you. I think they're on YouTube. But yeah, Full Moon.
So it's called Evil Bong?
Evil Bong. There's fucking, this is the sixth one.
Maybe I haven't. I just don't know that that's what it's called.
I think you do, yeah. You just
a lot of boobies in him.
And Cheech Marin. But all right, thank you guys for tuning in. Hopefully you guys enjoy the show. Definitely like all of our accounts for Marked for Death. I am Junior_Doom, Ryan the One Cam, and we have Eric Plays and Beryl Murano. Thank you guys for tuning in, and we will see you on 420. Make sure you follow all of our cool accounts.
420 will be our last episode. We're going to be canceling the podcast after this. So,
I wish. So many people wish.
Mark's quitting.
And bye.